clap for your world famous two-time champs and feel the power!
It's a new day, yes it is!
All right, everybody here, hold on.
Welcome to WWE Payback!
I don't know why this
One tag team will have the opportunity to become number one
contenders. My bottom
for
scroll
our
always gets weird.
WWE World Tag Team Championship!
Man, the New Day is over. With four
and
R's.
We want a ringside view, so we're gonna sit back and watch, sipping on some lemonade, something like Becky with the good hair.
And speaking of Beyonce, if you need to get one back on your man in order to make your relationship equal and loving again, talk to your boy Xavier Woods. I am on Twitter at Xavier Woods PhD.
Cheap plug.
And my DMs
cheap plug
are
from
open,
Xavier.
Baby.
It goes down in the DMs. Times are a changing. It's a new era in WWE.
Why?
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 Because New Day Rocks.
All right. So hopefully my audio is not too distracting for everybody. Welcome, welcome, welcome. I had to go grab myself a sixer because I wasn't going to sit down and watch wrestling with you guys for 3 hours without first doing this. So, wow. So, cold open. New Day cold opens the show.
It's all about you guys.
Very interesting. So, in the, I guess that might be why they had... They had Baron Corbin lose in the pre-show because it'd be really, really awkward if they had this whole thing about a new era.
Arrived.
And then, you know, somebody went, I've been all over the world. Lost their debut match.
Coming after that, you would never have ended up in WWE without me. Bada boom, realest guys in the room.
You're going to have to watch, too. Are you working out? Yeah, whatever, man. I'm gonna drink beer and... There we go.
I got to pump iron so I can beat you up, like I said in my tweet.
Indeed. Shit, is there anything over here that I can open beer?
A shoe. You can use a shoe. Don't people do that?
Can you go grab the thing?
See, this is the patriarchy, you guys.
And now.
Sorry, guys. I try to keep the volume pretty low. So here, let me try to do that even a little bit more. Hot start, ladies and gentlemen. We are going to begin with Enzo and Cass. on beanbag chairs. God, I love the New Day. With my official South by So Wasted button / bottle cap opener. Is that a Chewbacca jacket? That's amazing.
Well,
Man, Enzo getting to Mr. T levels of gold rope here.
I like his hair.
And this right here, this is Big Cass, and he's 7 foot tall, and you can't teach that. Bada boom, realest guys in the room, how you doing?
Man, these guys, over like Rover. How do you not look at these guys and just see dollar signs? These guys are amazing.
Board villains, you think you're gonna be number one contenders? Well, if my aunt had hair on her back, she'd be my uncle. You two are getting a 2016 Certified G beatdown. So forget the bygone era, let bygones be bygones. Hop in your DeLorean and go back to the future.
Vaudevillains, you come out here flexing like you're Arnold. More like, hey Arnold.
Man, they're running back the exact same NXT promo they cut on him.
I'm gonna tee off on your football heads. You should have never stepped off the stoop.
You should have never stepped off the stoop. They say that there is no elevator to get to success. You gotta take the stairs. But for people like me and Big Cass, that's why there's an escalator.
You look so tiny standing next to the big guy.
You should have tied your shoes, cause you're caught up and you get stuck downstairs.
And we will prove tonight that there's only one word to describe you, and I'm gonna spell it out for you.
S-A-W-F-T.
No, is it? Oh, it's my card?
And witness the debonair devastation of such exquisite sophistication. And in English, Simon Gotts, the Vaudevillain.
Well, here's the thing. Enzo and Gaz are so over that they're actually getting the Vaudevillains booed. So I would say, in terms of guessing the finish, it's probably a screw job finish, right? I don't know if they would have them lose clean to the Vaudevillains. MacBook Pro, their music sucks. Yeah, I mean, so here's the problem with the Vaudevillains, is that, like, they are a better technical team. And their gimmick is enough to get them cheers, but they're far better as faces than they are as heels. Chris Guy says the screwjob finishes with the Dudleys, but they kind of already paid off the Dudley thing.
To get here tonight to Payback. Welcome to a sold-out Allstate Arena in Chicago. Ringside, Michael Cole, the legendary JBL, and Byron Saxton. Are you guys ready?
You better believe we're ready.
It's a big way to kick it off. I mean, the finals. If you had a bracket, this match is what you call a bracket buster.
And an international feel to Payback here tonight. We are joined here at ringside by our German announce team of Carsten Schäfer and Sebastian Hackel.
Alles klar. An unseren Tischen natürlich. Das ist ganz klar.
Is it a New Day interference? I mean, maybe, but they're faces. Why would they interfere? And specifically, if they were going to interfere, would they interfere for screwy shit from the Vaudevillains? You know, Chris Guy says it's coming back. ENC and New Day don't make sense. Two most over teams in a heel face in heel face feuds. I mean, like, number one, I think that here's the biggest mistake that I think people make is that if you're trying to look too binary at like, oh, who's the heel, who's the face, like, you're going to miss out on a lot of really, really fun stuff. Like, ultimately, you just want big, compelling characters. Although, I'll tell you what, you come out, this is a, obviously a very rehearsed hot start. People are saying, don't you dare be sour. They think that you're pouting.
I'm pouting because our app delivery food has yet to accept our delivery.
Oh, yeah, sorry.
Not because of the wrestling.
Not because of the wrestling?
Mm-mm.
All right, I'm going to try and full screen this again. The last time I tried to full screen it, it crapped out, so I might lose this, but I'd rather do it at the beginning of the match. So here we go. Fingers crossed.
Ah, oh,
crap beans. All right, let me try to do it in regular Chrome. All right, everybody tell us what's happening.
There's the purple guy, and he's throwing around and getting thrown by the big guy.
Uh-huh.
There's a lot of yelling.
Uh-huh.
And their mustaches, their hipster mustaches, which would be well-suited in Oakland.
See, you want to know what? I feel like everybody wants to know... If the vaudevillains can translate, like, I feel like that's their pivot, is that they just become hipsters. And so, like, that's why they're doing, that's why all of their accoutrements. Ah, here we go. And now we try to full screen. Yeah, it worked. Because I feel like they haven't tried a hipster kind of angle, and I feel like, you know, it's about 5 years after hipster, making fun of hipsters was a thing, which is the ripe time for WWE to start doing it.
I have mixed feels about the poop on
the poop emoji on his butt.
Yeah. But also, like, the trucker girl thing, what do they call that?
Oh, like, the mud flaps?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I hate those.
Oh, dude.
But
he has the Chewbacca belt.
That's cool.
Oh, my God. Enzo sells like $1 million, though. Did it reject? WWE. I don't think anyone expected to make it to the finals of this tournament. Now, one match
away. Wow, man. Wow. Did you see the way that Amore said they were too busy. Whiplash. His head bouncing off the bottom
rope. And he may be out. Xavier Woods doing the, are they periscoping? Are the New Day periscoping? Oh, shit. Can't do that. This may be a serious situation here. The official
is talking to Enzo Amore, but Amore is yet to respond. So while you can't rebroadcast the WWE, you can periscope it.
Well, no, they've done a lot of stuff on Periscope before. Enzo Amore hit that bottom rope so hard. Face first, his head snapped back, and then he fell to the floor in a heap.
You don't realize you hit these ropes and you're not used to it. It can break a rib. These guys are
again. Watch this. Watch this impact, John.
So Xavier Woods is Snapchatting. He
okay.
That.
Oh, Amore. Oh, right face there, first, yeah. Right into the rope,
and it bounced off that mat.
And again, our doctor is here at ringside with Enzo Amore, who guys,
he
hasn't moved.
All right, listen, if this is a work, I'm getting worked, bro. All right, but
what a bad break for this team in this tournament to make it this far.
And again, this is
we've got a bad injury. Again,
oh, no.
Developed at ringside. You can see the emergency medical personnel are bringing a stretcher down here to work on Enzo Amore. And guys, again, Amore hit so hard, I believe the second rope and then into the bottom rope and fell to the
floor. He was trying to get his head underneath the rope, and he hit that rope, and that rope is just like a cable. It's as hard as it could be, and he hit his head on the mat. It looked like he's knocked himself completely out.
And again, this is just one of those situations that you never want to see happen in a WWE ring, but it's the nature of the competition.
So they're keeping the shot on them. This doesn't look like it's a work. Well, how sad, man. These guys were so over. State Arena in Chicago.
Yeah, you first of all hope that he's all right. It's a terrible break for this team that this has happened. For this young man, though,
yeah. Take a look at this one more time, and watch here.
Watch his head hit the mat.
Right there, yeah. Actually, it was the second rope, I believe, that he hit, and then he hit the bottom rope again on the way down. I thought initially it was just the bottom rope, but again, this is a Cass concerned about his partner as well here at ringside, as are his opponents, the New Day as well.
What a hard, I mean, I know these guys, they were so excited, so pumped up for this moment here tonight. And obviously the
I mean, it just seems so weird.
Thing here, but my gosh, I mean, you look at this moment for both these teams, and what a heartbreaking course of events here. This is.
And the doctor just here at ringside. Well, look, we also, you know, you understand, we have medical personnel that's best in the world. That is why they're here, and that's why they're around ringside.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, as the doctors and EMTs continue to work on Enzo Amore here at ringside, we're going to move on with our broadcast here tonight. Coming up next, an extremely personal rivalry between two young men who've known each other for 14 years. Sami Zayn.
Oh, this sucks.
Owens.
That this sucks so goddamn bad, man. Those two teams, those two Royal fucking Rumble board match. Teams. Like, and the New Day. Like, just so ready to fucking go and ready to explode, and then such a freak fucking injury. Because it's not like Enzo's fragile. And I hope he's all right. Obviously, first and foremost.
We actually met at a wrestling show.
We really hit it off. Because we were very similar, we were like-minded people.
I started wrestling for the same promotions as he did, and eventually we just kind of got lumped in together.
Traveling together and only together. I was there when he got married.
Well, Chris Guy says, hopefully it starts Raw. I mean, like, hopefully he's okay.
Pretty close.
We grew up together. We really did.
I mean, what a weird way to start. I mean, it is also really hard that now. I mean, this was the angle with Kevin Owens and Sami Zayn was like, you know, that he was repeatedly hitting his head on things until he went out. Yipes.
Sami did sign with WWE first. It's probably a moment I'll never forget. It was hard for me to see him achieve that goal first. To this day, it still bothers me.
And I remember he told me, look, we're not friends. We're like brothers. Well, if I'm a brother, isn't that family? Is that what you do for the family? A lot of people provide for their family without stabbing their brother in the back, right?
He should have known. He should have seen it coming. He's known me for so many years. I've always done what I had to do to get ahead. Unfortunately, when I got here, Sami stood in my way.
Ah!
I...
Wow, I'm having a hard time coming out of what a big bummer that is, man. Like, what a stinker. I'm sure everybody on Twitter's shitting their bricks off.
And I've been on a path ever since that keeps getting better and better.
Kevin Owens wins the Intercontinental title!
I had just had surgery, and I get this phone call that Kevin's about to debut. It was like getting kicked in the stomach.
Yeah.
He took my debut.
I mean, it looks like, everybody's as confused as we are. You gotta wonder what the finish of that match was gonna be. Oh, wait, is healed at the thing? Mad scene down here. Enzo can move his hands, getting loaded up and getting oxygen. Healed, are you at the show?
Enjoyed costing him his chance at the WWE Championship.
He came out there that night to screw me.
Oh, over. Quoting a Twitter.
If this is personal, it's because he's making it personal, not me. I'm a victim.
Yeah, I was gonna say I knew you were UK. Oh my God, that dragon suplex at WrestleMania, just insane.
Desire to be the best. Neither of us are going to advance our careers until this is sort of settled. My sights are focused on Payback. And in Payback on Kevin.
Yeah, they never gave... I mean, I assume that they'll probably say it's a no contest and then redo it unless... I mean, it depends on where Enzo is. No matter what, there's going to be talk about him concussion-wise. Jesus, I'll tell you what, though. If you're Kevin Owens and you're Sami Zayn, you know, after watching somebody go down like that, it's got to be in the back of your mind, right? You know, obviously you have to wrestle without the fear of injury or else, like, it's the quickest way to get injured. But if anything, it's almost, it's better that these guys have worked with each other so much. Yeah, Kevin does. Well, I mean, yeah, in the Stone Cold podcast, they said that Enzo and Cass travels with Kevin Owens.
Has claimed all along that he's going to take out the underdog of the underground.
His opponent from Montreal, Quebec, Canada, weighing in at 212 pounds.
There we go. The man who in 2014 finally brought a ska gimmick to wrestling. Or at least the WWE. Sami Zayn. You know, this is the problem, though, is as much, you know, as the classics as that these guys have had in ROH and what they've done in Ring of Honor. Or sorry, not, what's it called?
I don't really understand that. This skewed logic.
What's the Reseda promotion?
Sami Zayn's obviously jealous.
With all the Ring of Honor guys.
Of what?
God damn it. I can't think of it.
Who else?
PWG, Pro Wrestling Guerrilla. All the stuff they've done in Pro Wrestling Guerrilla, all the stuff that they've done in Ring of Honor. Like, it was all with Sami under a mask, you know? Which, like, he's so expressive. I mean, if anything, this is like...
The NXT brand back in 2013. It took
all right, so here's the meta, right? The meta is that Vince doesn't like to do anything that he didn't create. What we saw before is something he did not create, and that went, obviously, not as good as they would want. This is something he did not create. They're literally just running a feud from ROH, right? If this does not deliver... It's going to be a problem, which means these guys are going to go out of here. They're going to go, they are going to go out of their minds. And Sami is fired up, man. He is soaking up that babyface heat.
Sami Zayn has been obsessed with getting revenge on Kevin Owens.
Oh, it's his own fault. Look, when the Tiger turned on Roy, the Tiger didn't go crazy. The Tiger went Tiger.
Oh, look at it again. Oh, it's whipped into the barricade.
Kevin Owens said it is Sami Zayn's fault for not knowing what Kevin Owens would have done. You know what kind of friend he was.
And again, watch Sami Zayn launch himself over the top rope.
And that same token, Kevin Owens, you know what kind of man Sami Zayn is. To not let a grudge pass him by. To do whatever he's got to do to get some vindication.
Oh, it's more than a grudge.
Tell you what, I still just got that Enzo thing in the back of my mind. Like it's a head injury.
There's a heel kick. From Zayn.
That's so tough because they were looking so good in the ring too. I really love that they were kind of really folding in the style of Cass like throwing around Enzo as a weapon as part of like their move set, not just their finisher. I mean, I'm sure we're gonna see any news that comes in that people find. Just post it in the chat room so we can all see it.
That's exactly why he turned on Sami Zayn.
Zayn off the bottom rope, leapfrog over the top of Owens. Yeah, twisted means to justify your actions by Kevin Owens.
No, you can call it twisted brain, but not twisted means. He's not twisting the truth. That's truth to him, Byron.
And Sami Zayn delivering. Oh, was going
for yeah, the apparently, yeah. We've depressed Ashley to the point where she's leaving now.
Face first goes Sami Zayn, and now KO on the attack. And now shoulder first into the steel steps.
Hopefully we get something from Enzo.
Extremities, which is wonderful news. He's also talking. So again, Enzo moving his extremities. He is talking. He's being taken to a hospital. Hopefully we get some good news before we go off the air here tonight with Payback.
So he's got a concussion.
Great news. At least we heard this much. It's very positive.
Meanwhile, this fight continues between Owens and Zayn.
I mentioned that elbow a little earlier, John. That area is something Kevin Owens has targeted in the past of Sami Zayn.
Yeah. So, all right. I mean...
Straight kick to the face.
It's an extension of the nasty attitude that Kevin Owens has.
Cover by Owens, kick out by Zayn. One of the things, guys, Kevin Owens did here is he weathered that early emotional storm of Sami Zayn, and now he finds himself right back in control of this matchup where he needs to be.
Oh, look at that.
Kevin Owens doesn't put his emotion in stupid things like friendship.
What he
puts his emotion in winning titles.
And stabbing people in the back and lying to your
Yeah,
face.
Aubrey Citizen here on Twitter. Every time a wrestler gets hurt, it gets a little harder to keep being a wrestling fan. Man, I hear you. Like, it is.
Here's the cover, hook the leg, and a kick out.
Look at Kevin Owens even admitted.
It's a rough business, man. It's a real, real, real rough business with not a lot of money and a whole shit ton of risk.
Drop Zayn again.
So you're faulting him for being honest?
I'm explaining why he's done the underhanded things that he's done.
Oh, now mocking the ole from Zayn and kick right to the spine again. Now to the chin lock, Kevin Owens. Owens can be as nasty as they come.
Which is exactly why Kevin Owens has been...
All right, so let's get back on the ring here. What do we think as a finish here?
Sky's the limit for Kevin Owens. Just a lot of people question how he goes about it.
I almost think it ends with Kevin getting caught cheating or something like that, because you got to keep this going. This has got to play off at you know, SummerSlam or... Oh, God, that looks great.
Oh, watch Owens. Senton by Owens. Cover on Zayn. Is this enough? Hook for the leg. Got him. No, 2.5. Owens, John, dominating.
Absolutely dominating. You're right, Michael. He weathered that first emotional storm.
Oh, wait, did Kevin yell Headlock Island?
KO doesn't like you very much.
That's what I don't get. I mean, focus on your opponent. He's always got to take time to showboat and talk trash.
Wait a minute. We're right here in Chicago, one of the greatest trash talkers in the history of the world, Michael Jordan, who won 6 NBA championships while talking trash. The great ones can do that,
and
Byron.
Here comes Zayn. 3 forearms by Sami Zayn, looking to build a little bit of momentum. Whipped off the rope. Oh, it's caught him again with a high elbow. Zayn right back to the clothesline. Sami Zayn, perhaps on instinct, popped right back up after the elbow and delivered a wicked clothesline.
That's what emotion would do for you sometimes.
You guys good? Shut up. Good, baby, good.
Yeah, emotion can also take you out of your game plan.
What's interesting with these two is not just how well they know each other and the timing, but because a lot of the stuff they do is acrobatic, and obviously for Sami, he's a smaller guy, so the acrobatic element is kind of more expected. But also for Kevin, who's insanely acrobatic like that, they both just like have such a great idea of each other's like weight and momentum and stuff like that. Like everything just moves so fluidly.
Kevin Owens, straight boot to the face. Sami Zayn, wow!
Blue Thunderbomb for the win. Is it enough? Kick out at two.
Well, it'll be very interesting if they do a brand split. And you know, we started right as everything was getting going, so we haven't really had a chance to set everything up. But that's obviously the big talk going into this, is whether or not, with how they've set everything up, and we've heard rumors for the last 2 months that they are going to split this into a Raw show and a SmackDown show like they used to try to boost ratings.
Sit-down block by Kevin Owens.
With Shane hosting one and Stephanie hosting the other. I mean, effectively, storytelling-wise, which is what I'd probably focus on because that's the only thing I literally have anywhere close to knowing anything. The biggest difference is going to be on one show, there will be a reliable narrator, and on the other show, there will be an unreliable narrator, in that a heel manager can make everything that seems like it's going all right invalidated, and everything that is with a face commissioner, a face authority figure, is going to have to play by the rules. Oh, I love that move by Kevin.
Another near fall for KO. Now it's Kevin Owens who's got that look of disbelief on his face.
Uh-oh. Where's that frog splash? Oh, the false finish.
Frog splash was going to win one off Sami Zayn.
Look at the height here.
Oh, man.
Owens.
Wow. Picture perfect.
Like I said before, that's bigger than
the movement on Kevin Owens, man. What an athlete.
Frog splash.
And another near fall right here. Sami Zayn able to dig down deep and kick out. Sami is hurt.
Yeah, I mean, I guess, so here's the question, though, is, like, really, what does it get you?
Oh, Kevin Owens, what a collision in the corner. Yeah, I think it's about to get worse, too.
Like, it certainly gets you less time with your bigger stars, but then again, you probably have people like, you know, John Cena, who would like to work one day instead of 2 days. God, perfect counter. Oh. Oh, God, the reversals. Oh. Jizz. That was amazing. Oh, shit, I got to get the mark cam ready. Uh-oh.
Fans in Chicago. Incredible matchup. This match is as physical as we expected it to be. While we talk about this being the first.
Listen, I'm fine with them brand splitting. I would prefer that they still do joint pay-per-views. And I would prefer that one brand kept the main championship.
We're seeing it right now here. WWE in the future certainly looks bright.
Again, both men running to right hands from one another. And a second time. This time Owens goes low with a knee to the gut.
Powerbomb again.
Oh. Sami Zayn counters, rolls him up, shoulders down, puts both legs to the kick out.
Wow, that was
close. Oh, this crowd's hot, baby.
And Sami gonna run the tightrope. Oh no! Owens drops Sami.
Combo breaker. Shit, wait, hold on, we're going to have to get the mark cam. Hold on. Fuck, I don't want to leave this.
What a terrific counter by Kevin Owens. The thinking man's fighter.
Sami thought he had him here with Owens. Oh, right there on the lower back. Driving the knee.
That is a thing of beauty.
Look at the stain on the face of Kevin Owens.
You should stay down.
continuing to trash talk and mouth off to Zayn. Sammy's gonna take none of it. These two men can't stand each other.
Oh, they can't.
Oh, God damn it.
Same thing enough. One of the apron. Kevin Owens caught him.
Ah, I can't figure this out now. I gotta watch this. I'm sorry. We can't figure out the mark cam. I'm marking out too hard to figure out the mark cam. How long is this match going? This is like a WrestleMania length fucking match.
I think Sami Zayn, he wants to beat Kevin Owens 1-2-3, John.
Again, that's a stupid emotion.
All right, understanding that this is a cold, calculated way to do this. Understand that any wrestler who sits, ha! Oh, that spot's never not rad. Any performer that after a rough spot stays on the mat for longer than they might otherwise, this crowd is going to be insane for, having you already set the stage with a legit injury, a head injury no less.
Now Zayn trying to get that carcass of Kevin Owens back to the ring as we take another look at this beautiful DDT. Sami Zayn's got to feel it. He's got to feel like he's got Kevin Owens right where he wants him.
Yep, big fecal chant. Here we go. The haluva kick. Oh, no. Oh, no. Into the ropes. No. Oh, Papa Powerbomb, this is it. Oh, look at that. Clean win by KO with the busted nose. That's fine. Sammy can fight from underneath. This rivalry is way better with Kevin Owens gloating and Sammy fighting. I mean, remember, Sammy's best run in NXT included a clean loss to Titus O'Neil. And they built Titus O'Neil up to be a goddamn monster. And both those matches they had were rad. No, let him, yeah.
Sami Zayn might not either.
Let him disrespect. Disrespect Sammy.
Talk about two men who absolutely pushed each other to the limit.
I'm that guy. Great.
Run in your camera.
Oh,
it's
no,
not showing up.
What's that for?
It's plugged in.
Oh, he wants a post-match promo. Yeah, it's not showing up. You did.
Ask me about beating Sammy. Ask me about it. Ask me about beating Sammy now.
This is fucking great.
Kevin, do you think the rivalry is finally over between you and Sami Zayn?
That's not what I told you to ask, but fine. I did it. I beat Sami Zayn. You saw it. You all saw it. I beat him. And
I finally put to rest the question that people have been asking about us for 14 years. I beat Sami Zayn. Kevin Owens is the better man.
That's the most negative reaction Kevin Owens is going to get in Chicago.
You know what? No, I'm not done. Because now that I beat Sami Zayn and prove I'm
the best,
you know what I'm going to do?
No, but it's a very smart wrestling city.
Here's what I'm going to do. I can finally refocus and get back my Intercontinental Championship.
Look at that.
Kevin, that match is next. Do you think The Miz might retain his championship?
Oh, the match is next. That's wonderful. You know what? I don't care if Miz retains the championship. But on that note, you know what? Thank you for the invitation. Yes, I will do commentary for the next match with you, Byron.
All right.
Zoo enthusiast Kevin Owens now joining the commentary table. Oh my God, he's amazing. He is awesome. He is everything that I want in wrestling, and I am so excited that he is a part of it now. He is apparently going to join both the German and English announce teams. He's going to give Byron the shitty seat. That's great. So, yeah, you wonder if they do brand split, then do you keep them on either side? Because now it's fine. Listen, they have a big match. They obviously set up that there's more to come. Sammy fights from the underneath, and then it gets to a point where he's going to deal with where he's going to, you know, a cross paths with Kevin again at a big moment. He'll have, as KO brought onto Steph's show, it's being a big deal that him and Zayn signed up as I want to make this guy a living nightmare together. Yeah, that's good. Is anybody looking forward to the cartoon? I'm not, but that's fine. That's Mick Foley. That's I think my favorite wrestler of all time. Yeah. No, I mean, he certainly looks haggard, and he's only gotten fatter and more haggard.
The Intercontinental Championship. Quiet on the set. Can we please have quiet on the set?
There we go, ladies and gentlemen. The Miz, legitimate heel heat. Before, let's go ahead and get some rapid reaction here on Twitter about the last match. Ice Warm, I love the promo. Let's get back a little bit. Owens versus Cesaro versus Zayn for the IC title. Yes, please. Sasha Banks and Bret Hart in the back. A wife. His real life wife. Ashley, do you have any commentary on Maurice, the Miz's real life wife and now on screen valet?
Needs more sparkles.
So she used to be a lady wrestler in the WWE and then was away for a while, and now she's back.
Why have you decided to join us for this Intercontinental Championship match?
Because this match is of great interest to me.
Kevin Owens in a cowboy hat.
That match matters quite a bit to me, Michael, because didn't you just hear what I said when Byron rudely came into the ring and interrupted my celebratory victory? Whatever I was trying to say just now, he interrupted me, threw me off. I want that title back. Yes, very nice.
Chris Guy, why is she back? She sucks all the energy out of the building. I don't think so, man. I think she's great.
Miz won the championship the night after WrestleMania when he defeated Zack Ryder
because his wife slapped Ryder's dad. And that's the end of the day.
days of our life.
But his dad actually deserved it.
Of course he deserved it. You see what he did?
Okay, no, you can't shoot. You have to shoot him from that angle for the James Bond thing to look good. Also, this is my new favorite gimmick in wrestling. Watch this, Ash. Comes to in a suit, right? Looking good, looking fine. Undoing the cufflinks. And then rips all of it off. I love it. I love it, Mago. I love it. Yeah, wait, are we really still having a conversation about Maryse, man? Number one, she's foreign, so she has an accent, which always means that she's a bad guy. Number two, she's gorgeous, and his whole shtick, Miz's whole shtick, is that he's a famous Hollywood actor. I love the fact that they've dialed into it more with the whole like, take two, take three, take four, or, like, quoting famous movies, and he's doing monologues and, like, giving himself, I think I can do better lines.
On his shoulder, of course, that injured shoulder cost Cesaro about 4 months of action.
I injured his shoulder. I did that. Did you know that? You did?
You did everything here.
Yes.
Problem is like, I think that these guys can work well together. I just don't know if... I mean, it's going to be hard to stand up to that last match because those are guys who have done that for a decade plus.
You claim you'll get a chance against one of these two men, whoever wins the title here tonight.
I will take that chance.
And look at Cesaro, the athletic Swiss Superman, Cesaro with an arm drag.
Oh, man. This has got a really weird, like, kind of indie feel to it. There's a lot of, like, really funny or, like, fun, interesting, silly, like, indie sort of shit to this so far. Like, even before the Enzo Cass Vaudevillain things ended with the Enzo injury, they were doing that, like, kind of super choreographed, really calisthenic-y kind of spots there.
Well, many people believe that pound for pound, Cesaro is the strongest man in WWE today.
Yeah, well, he's not the smartest, because that would go to me.
That's a good point.
He's not the best either, get that right. That also goes to me.
And Byron, you're as popular in Chicago as Miss O'Leary's Cal.
Appreciate that, John.
I appreciate that, John.
And look at this for the championship kick out, too.
Miz, is that all you got? I do way better than you against Cesaro. Come on, Michael, even you have to admit
Let's take another look.
Oh, yeah.
Cesaro. That tilt the world backbreaker. Knee to the spine. Miz kicks out. Oh!
Oh, Jesus, Cesaro.
Cesaro.
He is an insane athlete.
Dominating as Miz's wife, Maryse, looks on at ringside.
It's funny, Miz actually claimed the other week that Cesaro would be held back because of his shoulder.
Byron, did you get that suit?
He certainly does. Is mac and cheese on the way?
I may or may not.
Maybe.
Mac and cheese is maybe on the way, everybody. Just to get everybody. Listen, mac and cheese is going over tonight.
We're very hungry, guys.
We are. We're hungry people.
I just ate a half a pint of ice cream.
Marv, why'd you do that?
Hungry.
We're trying to do wrestling commentary
sad.
Here.
I was sad from the earlier.
You were
wrestling.
Sad for Enzo?
So I drowned it in my sorrows.
A half a pint for Enzo. Bada boom. Realist ice cream in the room. How you doing?
Regardless of what you might think, regardless of what you might think of what his wife just did, what he did after was very smart. He pulled Cesaro down by that arm. Now he's going straight for the shoulder. I don't like Miz much. But he's almost as smart as I am in that ring. I'll give him that.
So, KO, would you rather face Miz or Cesaro if you had an opportunity at the Intercontinental title?
I would rather face you, but that's not going to happen. Ugh. I'll face
that's
either
great.
One of these guys, and I'll walk out Intercontinental champion. That's all you need to know.
Suplex by Miz.
By the way, I always wonder, I would love to talk to some of these guys that, like, can do commentary or are fun at doing commentary. You got to wonder how much of it is also them saying, you know, once I'm done in the ring, you know, commentary is the better way to go than, say, like, booking agent or something like that. Because commentary doesn't have to work weekends.
Intercontinental champion.
Lost the championship at WrestleMania in a ladder match.
Because of Sami Zayn. And just destroyed Sami Zayn.
Right there, Miz.
You always leave the important parts out.
I swear, Foley tried commentary and couldn't do it. But Foley was never great at commentary when he was a wrestler. like, unless he was just creeping everybody out as Mankind. Like, he's great at promos. It's two very, very different skills.
If I was in there with him, I would already ripped off Cesaro's arm and beat him. No, Miz is trying to do his worst, but he's just not as vicious.
I mean, then there's also the fact that you have to deal with Vince McMahon in your goddamn ear.
Because you're looking over at me with that little smirk, and it's pissing me off.
This is great, Byron and Kevin. You gotta wonder, are they setting up Byron Kevin, or is he gonna do the Alex Riley filler feud?
Let me bring something to light here. I know a lot about Sami Zayn. Sami Zayn could beat either one of those guys. I know that for a fact, and I just beat Sami Zayn. So what does that tell you? It tells you that I am going to beat whoever comes out of this match Intercontinental Champion and take it back. That's what it tells you. Thank you, Kevin. You're welcome, Mike.
It almost sounds to me, Kevin, like you may be trying to perhaps convince yourself that you could beat one of these guys for the Intercontinental Championship.
It almost sounds like you're trying to convince yourself that you're a good commentator, but everyone knows that's not the case.
Oh, my God. It's amazing how much better Kevin Owens makes Michael Cole. Michael Cole's great right now. You only got to wonder, though, is if in a longer form, in a longer timeline, whether or not Kevin Owens' accent works against him.
He's got those legs, great bind around Cesaro's midsection. You're right, Cesaro's in a lot of trouble here.
Cesaro just trying to maneuver himself, maybe trying to grab onto that bottom rope. Yeah, but Miz doing a great job keeping him in toward the center of the ring here.
Cesaro turning around here. Cesaro realizes that's the only way he can get out of that move.
Great move by Miz, adding this to his repertoire.
He can always do the French announcing. Something tells me that that is not not quite as lucrative.
Back to a vertical base, the power of Cesaro. Look at Cesaro.
Oh, my God.
Craig in the hold, and now set Miz up. Oh, wow. That is complete power. Vertical suplex by Cesaro.
Bad shoulder at all.
Shut up, Byron.
FLS Carnage says, CM Punk was great at commentary, and you have to wonder in a different world, if not this world in the next few years, you know, if he can reconcile with WWE, if he would be a great commentator once he's kind of done being physical. Although you get the sense that he's, you know, he would probably want to write or do other stuff. Who knows?
If I never have to take another uppercut from Cesaro again, that'll be too soon.
Well, you'd have to.
Oh, shut up, Mike. Stop telling me what I have to do.
Kevin Owens is so great.
Cesaro with another uppercut. Cesaro's just rolling with those uppercuts. This is seriously bad news for Miz.
Oh, is it? Is it bad news?
Come on. You have to, like, say it because we're on stream.
Talking to the mac and cheese gods.
Well, then talk to the mac and cheese gods and let everybody listen.
Where's my fucking mac and cheese? That's why I was mumbling.
They feel like they would if I slapped you in the face.
Oh, it's great. Cesaro. Cesaro feels like he's putting it together a little bit. Cesaro is like a mean streak away from being the main event guy. But I mean, that's the problem, is that he just has such an insanely likable moveset that it's hard. It's hard to have him be anything other than a super over babyface.
Please.
This is insane. Deadlift superplex. Tell you what, this is what we like to call in the business a high work rate pay-per-view so far.
What the hell are you watching? Cesaro just picked Miz up off the apron and delivered a suplex over the top rope.
FLS Gunner says maybe Barrett can do commentary. He has a great voice and is rumored to be leaving to be a sports commentator, but I think that's why. He's going to go do real sports.
All right.
I think it's hilarious. I think it's impressive.
There we go. No.
Why are there two clowns in the audience?
They have one famous clown fan, I don't know. I don't know. Because people like to dress up. Because okay. wrestling is a goose activity. And there's a lot of goose stuff that happens. Man, look at that. I don't know if Cesaro's connecting. Oh, look at that. Oh man, now that is heel work by Miz. Is it Frank the Clown and his friend FLS Carnage?
That's nice, but you're not going to see us fight every day because he's done.
Source says Owens is another level.
That is correct. Astute observation.
For the neutralizer, landed on his feet. Now he backslides the champ. Shoulders again, two count. Another near fall. Miz caught him right in the back shoulder, but he ran into an uppercut.
Hit me, I'll hit you harder.
Oh, shoulder first. The bad shoulder
that
into the steel
post. That can't be good.
Post.
Here we go.
And now Miz from behind.
Skull-crushing finale. That's it. Miz with a...
Oh, God. Thank God he kicked out. I actually would have been annoyed with that. I'm getting worked, man. I'm getting worked. Is Frank the Clown the boyfriend of Noelle Foley? Yeah, apparently. I don't know. Unless they had a fight or something. Sami Zayn from out of nowhere! Oh my God, I'm so excited! Oh, Mark Cam, why isn't the Mark Cam working? Oh my God, this is so great! Nothing's over! Nothing's ever over! They will fight forever! And here we go! God, the psychology on all this is so fucking great. This crowd is like jizzing and jizzing and jizzing and jizzing.
John Wayne.
Yeah, he was had a beautiful Maureen O'Hara. Tough guy.
Vom.
So this is like a like old as the modern sport professional wrestling move, the giant swing, right? But for whatever reason, it was always so goofy. Nobody ever did anything with it. Oh no, it's gonna be a DQ because they're fighting into the ring. He's tapping. Oh! Here we go. Four way for Extreme Rules. That's how you do a roll up finish. That's how you do a roll up finish. That was, oh my God, you guys, they took a story beyond one match. That's fucking great. Oh, boom. Boom, bitch.
Miz stole that victory. Stole it. It wasn't his fault the referee wasn't paying attention. He didn't call Sami Zayn or Kevin Owens to fight.
We got a neutralizer.
Now Cesaro's a sore loser. Owens. And now Sami Zayn in the mix.
So if they brand split, if they brand split, is the Intercontinental Championship the biggest championship in SmackDown? And do all four of these guys go to SmackDown?
And at the end of the day, it's Kevin Owens standing tall. And as he told us on commentary, he has his sights set on the Intercontinental Championship. And apparently the champion.
Oh, but Maryse gets him out. Oh my God, you guys. Oh my God. Oh my God. I'm loving all of this so much. I'm loving all of this so much, you guys. You guys, I'm having a moment. Let's go ahead and see. Yeah, look at this. JC Bobbitt, everything that just happened was perfect. Once again, I'll say it again. The most devastating move of all time is the roll up, schoolboy for life. Sammy and Kevin were destined to do this forever. Seriously, barring the horrible end of that tag match, everything that on the show has been amazing. Everything is an A+ so far. Owens is the best troll announcer. I might actually have to hit up Andrew. I'll hit up Andrew's area.
Zayn and Owens continue their fight. The referee was busy with them.
I want to see whether or not he wants to talk real quick about what we've seen. Oh, shit. I only have him on DM. Oh, look at him biting it. Oh, my God. All of this is just too good.
$95 a month for a smaller network. In other news, we have a mac and cheese update. It's on the way. It will be here in approximately 5 to 7 minutes. Furthermore, it will be in my tummy in 6 to 8 minutes. And that's all for your mac and cheese update.
Yeah.
And now for a limited time, switch to Cricket and get a $50 bill credit. Cricket Wireless. Something to smile about.
All right, so I just DM'd Andrew Zarian.
Oh, check out this scene. Guys, don't forget, tonight we're going to find out who is going to become full controller of Monday Night Raw. Will it be Stephanie McMahon or will it be Shane McMahon? We will find out tonight.
Yeah, Mr. McMahon is going to make the decision here tonight live.
Randall, boo, ads on the paid network. Well, also that's ads on a pay-per-view, so.
Because I think they're about to get out of control pretty quickly. Because coming up next.
Also, I'd rather watch ads for $9.99 a month than pay $15 a month.
To take on Chris Jericho. For Chris Jericho, it was all about being embarrassed.
Shut your damn mouth and listen to what I have to say. Tonight is the biggest highlight reel of all time because my guest, he's a multi-
See now here. Is what I'm really, really excited about is that, like, now you've set this fucking bar so high that, like, Chris Jericho and Dean Ambrose are the ones that have to top it, man. MacBook Pro, is that Bobby Lashley with Steph? No. I don't know if that's racist or just not up on the product. That is Apollo Crews.
Jericho loves to say that he's the best in the world at what he does, and he likes to say it a lot.
The best in the world at what I do.
But I'm pretty good at what I do, too. I come out here every night, and I fight for respect, and I earn respect.
Kevin Owens taking on Dean Ambrose. This is our main event. Wait a minute!
Chris Guy says they'd have to steal the show at this point. I mean, they don't gotta steal the show, but they gotta do something, right?
Light up your stupid little Christmas tree jacket and get out here. You should be thanking me, Ambrose, because just being in the same ring with me puts you on a different level, baby. I want you to apologize to me. You stupid, look at me when I'm talking to you, idiot. I want you to apologize to me for stealing the highlight reel. Apologize now. I'm sorry. I'm sorry that you're walking around everywhere wearing a scarf. I'm sorry that you're an insecure egomaniac, but I am not sorry for this.
So now here's what I really want out of this match is like fun. Because they both have an ability to be fun. I want them to both get, like, personally embarrassing with each other. Like, this one doesn't have to be, like, a super slobber knocker. Are we just naming every black wrestler in the chat now? Is Ahmed Johnson... When Ahmed Johnson's name is getting mentioned, you know that we're just naming every black wrestler we can think of. Oh, wow. Jericho doesn't get the full blackout? What the fuck? Oh, there we go. V
viscera lost a lot of weight. Stop it, guys. You guys.
Viscera is dead. Listen, man, if we're going to be naming every... Mac and Cheese update. Mac and Cheese is on the way. It is going to get picked up from downstairs.
Aqui em Chicago, a gente mostrando tudo o que acontece no Payback. Também vamos estar juntos, pay-per-views. É o Brasil com a gente na WWE. Дорогие друзья, огромное спасибо, что вы с нами. День расплаты WWE.
Mac and Cheese. Hey, look at that! Funaki!
Funaki's gotten better over the years.
Still number one announcer.
Yes, he is. I love Funaki.
I wonder if they have all those people there now more because they're trying to appeal to more countries for the WWE network. That actually is that's kind of interesting because I know that a lot of the times the reason why they would have different announcers is because the networks that were carrying the broadcast would pay the way, which is why there weren't always live announcers from other countries. But I wonder if they're just putting in their own announcers to do it, if WWE's paying their way for everything. That's interesting. Uh-oh.
Tonight, you recall Enzo Amore hitting his face on the ropes here, falling outside the ring, was treated by medical personnel. Well, we are still awaiting more info from the medical center here tonight. We can tell you that Enzo is now undergoing testing, and he's able to move his extremities, his arm and his legs. And as soon as we get more information, we're going to pass it along. But we can tell you Enzo is able to communicate with the medical staff.
That's good news.
All right, so that sounds very concussion-y.
Set for Chris Jericho and Ambrose, one-on-one at WWE Payback. And again, I mentioned it a little bit.
Chris Guy says, what about the Cruiserweight tournament that lends to a brand split? Nah, not necessarily. I mean, that's more kind of just an extension of NXT than it is a brand split.
Chris Jericho was host to Highlight Reel for 13 years. He felt like Dean Ambrose has disrespected him.
Although the most interesting rumor... The most interesting rumor is what's happening now with Sinclair Broadcasting and TNA and the WWE. The idea that the network being a place where you see ROH pay-per-views, or it has access to ROH pay-per-views from the past, and it has access to TNA pay-per-views from the past. That is interesting.
Ambrose in the walls of Jericho.
Look, go back to Shane McMahon, who made this match. He gave Chris Jericho his marching orders.
Do we get Balor tonight? I don't know if we get Balor tonight because... Although, I don't know. Like, why would it make sense for them to change the title at the house show?
Loki the boat builder here. Looks like Dean Ambrose has something to prove.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have a mac and cheese update. A homeroom mac and cheese delivered to our home in Oakland, California.
Watch out against Ambrose. Hats being abused tonight.
See, this is what I want. This is the silly shit I want. Getting chased around the ring. I love silly shit like this.
Jericho went for the clothesline and Ambrose met him with a wicked crossbody.
Sense Jericho's kind of been lost in his own greatness. I mean, he expects Ambrose to be thanking Jericho for this match, thanking Jericho for this opportunity.
Oh, look, that's something bad. Byron, you go get lost in your own average. How about that?
saying is getting lost in the greatness could prove to be a disadvantage.
Will we see Finn Balor tonight?
Take his focus away from a guy like Dean.
That is a very interesting question.
Chris Jericho knows exactly how dangerous Dean Ambrose is.
It would
is.
Make sense, right? Because they just filmed like four more weeks of NXT stuff. So you could have moved the title on NXT TV.
Jericho looking for a follow-up. And Jericho. Right to the face of Ambrose. And just like that, so quickly, Chris Jericho takes control. Jericho's called himself a once-in-a-lifetime superstar. We saw a once-in-a-lifetime debut right here in Chicago. Whoa, Ambrose in a clothesline. August 9th, 1999.
Wait, is Zayas in the building? Or is that a tweet?
Changed the landscape of WWE forever.
Yeah, Ambrose mocking Jericho there a little bit.
Jericho walked out that night.
Ice Storm Jerry, it seems like the WWE wanted Balor immediately. Why drop out a house show, not an NXT pay-per-view? Or even on NXT television. I mean, that's the thing. Is like you could just move it at a show, right? FLS Carnage says Balor Joe 4 is at TakeOver in June. Maybe. Anything can happen in the WWF. It keeps Balor strong, losing it off television. Wait, was Balor at the NXT shows in Orlando? Did Balor wrestle during the NXT tapings? Because that's really all we need to know, right?
For very good reason. Can't argue with the accomplishments. Six-time world champion, nine-time intercontinental champion, seven tag team titles.
You're like a parent.
Yeah, someone who doesn't care about spoilers, go check those results and tell me if Finn Balor worked any of the four weeks.
Disrespected. He was embarrassed and humiliated a couple of weeks ago by Ambrose. Had so many great stars on the highlight reel. Chris Jericho comes out here one day and finds out that Shane McMahon has arbitrarily canceled it without consulting him.
Oh, they announced Baylor Joe 4 at the tapings. Finn Balor. Okay, so he came out. So, yeah. I mean, if he's still in the NXT stuff, that's super weird, though. Unless they want to, I mean, listen, Kevin Owens basically worked a month on the WWE roster and the NXT roster, so.
And a drop kick. Chris Jericho caught Ambrose. Cover. Hook of the leg. Is it enough here on Dean? And a kick out at two. Now Jericho mocking the sold out crowd of 13,250 in Chicago as we take another look.
Wow, I kind of forgot that we still got that Charlotte Natty match. I'm looking forward to that.
Come on, Ambrose. Jericho wants to. Make sure Ambrose feels the same embarrassment.
Oh, shit. Hold on.
Rope right into the Adam's apple. And Ambrose gasping for breath, and Jericho with a kick to the spine. One thing about Chris Jericho, John, when he realizes he has the upper hand, he is relentless.
Absolutely. He's been in enough big matches. He knows how to close these matches. He knows how to win the big matches.
You've been in the ring with Jericho, John. What is it about Chris Jericho?
Update. Andrews Arian is dealing with his fussy baby, and then we'll be calling in on Skype.
Chris Jericho capitalizes. Plus, look, he broke in and in one of the hardest places you could in Japan where he's wrestling with the light heavyweights.
Yeah, oh, no. Brett looks awesome considering the fact that he was just, you know, in surgery for cancer.
Like he never misses a beat. That chop will drive Ambrose back toward the corner, and that went into the corner. And Jericho with went for the running. Oh, and Ambrose able to.
I love Jericho's tights. Jericho's tights are so fucking like dad cool. Recently divorced, father of two. That is what I would describe Jericho's tights as.
Start swinging.
Hey, Chicago used to see that all the time with Hawk of the Road Warriors. He made a name for themselves here in the Chicago street fight.
Ice Worm, any more Enzo news? I turned up the sound with the last one. It's the same stuff. He is communicating with the staff, and he can move his arms and legs, which was the initial update. So he said he's undergoing testing now. So they'll probably come back and just say that he had a concussion and, you know, everything's fine. What did I just say? I hear about Brett and cancer, says Stacy, and FLS Carnage fills in correctly that Brett had prostate cancer, got surgery for it, and now he's doing all right.
Just makes things up as he goes along.
Well documented. Well, yes. Documented because me and Michael have said it.
Standing switch by Ambrose. Catches an elbow by Jericho and another. And here's Chris Jericho. Ambrose sends him over the top rope. Able to land on the apron. Jericho going to climb up to the top rope here. Jericho. Oh! That axe handle brings Ambrose down.
Amtrak or Brett? No. Bret Hart. Bret the Hitman Hart, Stacy. A little bit of cartoon physics there.
Now Ambrose with a swinging neck breaker. Ambrose to look to put Jericho away. Near fall for Dean Ambrose.
Well, Dean Ambrose is his conundrum. Rob, you think everything he does is all erratic and crazy. He does a beautiful wrestling move like that.
This goes with the flow, whatever he feels at the moment. Sometimes
I think I've said this before, but I'll say it again. I hate the definition of Dean Ambrose as crazy. Crazy is the worst descriptor in the English language, in any kind of narrative, anything. It's so terrible. You don't know what crazy is. Crazy is unpredictable, right? But is he unpredictable violent? Is he unpredictable funny? Is he crazy silly? See, and listen, everybody else is saying better descripting words. Chaotic, gives no fucks. Like, all that says more than crazy. Well, the fucking rhinestones on his shitty tights sparkle in the lights. Chris Jericho sits down on the Walls of Jericho as Dean tries to make his way to the edge of the ring, reaching. At this point, he's either going to pass out or give up. His head hits the mat in exhaustion. There can only be so much left in Dean Ambrose. Reaching now on his knuckles. Right, gets to the ropes, breaks the hold. Ladies and gentlemen, this match continues.
So it takes a lot out of you. So even though Dean Ambrose got out of this, the damage has been done.
Oh, wow. Collision.
Straight. Look to the face.
Fancy there.
Son of a...
Jericho sent through the second rope by Ambrose, and he hits our table hard.
What? Ashley was yelling and screaming about this mac and cheese, and now it's been in here for 10 minutes, and she has not come in to eat it.
Driving Jericho back first off the German announce table. Watch the impact. Boom. Oh, boy.
Uh-oh. Resets the count, goes back out for Jericho, puts him up on the table.
He's going to do to Jericho what Jericho did to him Monday Night on Raw. He's going to use his finishing move against Chris Jericho.
Looking for dirty deeds in front of everybody. Oh, blocked by Jericho. I mean, he's not going to count him out. He's not going to tap out on the table. Dean blocks it anyway. Uh-oh. Into the timekeeper's nook. And now we get our first count.
Jericho's back to his feet. Ambrose hasn't moved.
See, I love this. This is great. This is fantastic. This is exactly what I wanted out of this match. All the goofy wrestling shit. The slow count. Oh, wait, here we go. For the finish, we are joined now, a run-in by guys from Queens, Mat Men host Andrew Zarian. Andrew, welcome, hey, sir.
Hey, how are you?
Fantastic. I just wanted to give you a call because I really think that this is like the best start for a pay-per-view that we have had in WWE in a very long time. Now, obviously, not counting the injury to Enzo, which is really... It shows you how great everything else was that they were able to, have as hot of a match there, and then a match after that, as transpired. What are your thoughts?
Oh, it's tremendous! I mean, this is one of their best pay per views in a long time. I mean, everything, top to bottom, has been good. The fact that they are now telling stories with the finishes, is really, really. It's not interesting. It's shocking because they've kind of gone away from that, right? Like, they do blow-offs and it leads to nothing. But now it seems like they're really pushing this concept that, okay, every match means something.
Yeah.
The winners go on to do something and the losers go on to do something. And everything is kind of flowing properly. I'm curious on how this match is going to finish, the Dean Ambrose and Jericho match. Because if this also leads into something... It's a total change in booking mentality, which I think is what they're doing.
But I think that this doesn't exactly have the onus of having to do that because Dean, I mean, this is kind of a rest stop for Dean, assuming that it's a rest stop for Dean, especially if they do a brand split, that he's going to be involved in whatever is the highest title in either side. The biggest question is, and I'm sure we could all probably figure out how this match is going to end if we check out, whatever Jericho's appearance schedule is.
Yeah. I don't, it's exciting. When they said it's a new era, it seems like it is a new era. I mean, the fact that they have, the guys are out and commentating with the other guys, and it doesn't seem as structured as it normally is.
Well, it doesn't seem as limited, right?
Because, limited, yeah, that's a better word, yeah.
There's always just every story is every story. And it's the same on Raw, it's the same on SmackDown, it's the same on the pay-per-views. And, like, if you're feuding with one person, you only interact with that person, and that's it for, whatever. Even in a tag match, you're usually, whenever you're in the ring with somebody who's not your feud mate, it takes 5 seconds, and then you just get back to whatever the heat is. That was what was great before with that last series, was that it was almost a swerve to the audience that they let a story go for more than one match, right?
Yeah, isn't it interesting that WrestleMania at this point was like a nothing,
Well, I mean, listen, WrestleMania was there to get 100,000 people in a building, and WrestleMania
also
got 100,000 people in a building.
It wasn't the WrestleMania they wanted,
Sure, but it was decimated by injuries, and that's what that is. What they're doing now, and listen, they have to pay a price for it because the ratings are down. But you have to get people invested to build them up to the heights that you want to, and it seems more than ever now that they seem to be committing to it.
Yeah, Vince works his best when his back is against the wall. I mean, historically, that's how he's been when he's had competition and when he was getting, decimated by the federal government and decimated by Turner. That's when he does the best because he takes risks. You look at a company, I mean, I know a lot of people watching this and a lot of both our audience, they're in the tech, they're into technology.
Yeah.
Apple did great when their back was against the wall and they had no other options. They had to do, they had to take risks and they had to do something great. I think WWE is right now in the position where, listen, we have to get our act together. They're not going anywhere, but when USA sees the ratings plummeting and it's time to renegotiate that contract, you know what? It's not going to look good for them if they continue on this trend.
Well, yeah, and the interesting thing is that they'll always be on USA because they still draw great for USA. They just don't draw great for them historically.
Yeah. It's interesting. I mean, it's the fact that you got Jericho out there and he's still working. I mean, Jericho's doing great and he's putting guys over and, I absolutely love it. I love everything that they're doing right now.
Well, and this match so far...
Because both of us, we talk about this for, we enjoy talking about. About it to have an audience, and it kind of sucks when we're like, well, this is great, and that's great, and this is great. I know a lot of people like to hear the negative, but I'm not really seeing a lot of negative with this card so far.
I mean, number one, even when it's not great, it's pizza, right? And I like and listen, we got a bunch of great pizza places around here. I love Boot and Shoe. I also love Domino's, and it's fine, right? Like, I like pizza in general. I like WWE when it's bad. Jericho now biting Dean's hair, which is amazing. This is exactly what I wanted out of this match, was, like, big, hairy, like, pro wrestling, like, long counts, heels slapping the back of the face's head, that kind of stuff. And that is exactly what we are getting. Lionsaw. Oh, gets the knees.
I just signaled for my father, because my father's helping me with the baby. My wife is in Puerto Rico. I just signaled him to get me a tall boy of Budweiser.
Oh, listen, that is a crucial move from the manager on the apron.
Yeah. I'm looking. This is, you know, I see Frank the Clown's there in the crowd.
Yeah, where does Frank the Clown live, and how is he everywhere? Is he a rich kid?
I don't know what his deal is, but he's with Noel Foley.
Well, there's that. So I assume that he was in New York or the island area, right? And there we go. Dean goes over clean in the middle of the ring with a dirty deeds after a blocked counter. That you got to feel
is that what just happened? You're a little ahead of me.
Oh, I'm a little ahead. Sorry about that.
Yeah. Oh, no, it's fine. This is it's interesting. You know, did you hear the rumors about, I don't know how much this has picked up. I may have been one of the sources for this rumor, but WWE Network is kind of looking to expand their catalog with their pricing. I know that they sent out a survey saying, like, hey, well, how would you guys feel about, you know, a $12.99 package to have Raw and SmackDown the following day? But they are also looking at possibly having Evolve and Pro Rev and all these other indie groups that they're kind of affiliated with on the network now.
So, and then the bigger rumor that we had mentioned before was the idea, okay, so here we go, Jericho being a freak on the edge. You wanted further storylines? Look at this. Something's happening after the match. They're not just going to go to package. Jericho being a baby. Let's see if anybody else comes out.
Well, this is interesting. I like it when Jericho loses his mind.
I was
going to curse. I don't know if you curse on the show.
Oh, no. Yeah, this is a random dude. This is a barely legal live stream where, you know, we're basically just playing like low audio of the pay-per-view while I talk over it.
You know what I literally redid my lighting in my bedroom.
Oh, you should not have done that because you're not even on camera right now.
Yeah,
so.
I realize that. Yeah.
Yeah. Actually, we can't put you here. Let me put you in the corner here.
Yeah, you know, it seems like somebody watched. I don't want this going to come out snarky, but it looks like somebody watched Invasion Attack from New Japan, their pay-per-view, and is like, hey, this is interesting. They're actually making everything count.
Here we go. Moro Ronaldo and AJ Styles, a phrase that you would have thought was ridiculous 1 year ago.
Gallows help you gain an advantage over Roman Reigns. And I've got to ask you, is that what we're going to see tonight?
Let me see if I can redo my stream. Come on. Can you throw me that remote? The little one right next to you? Yeah. Thank you. Let me see if I could redo this. Because I am really behind. I'm like a good minute and a half behind.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Another thing I'm looking forward to is that Camp WWE show.
Are you?
Yeah, I kind of am. I'm curious to see what they actually do with it because it's TVMA. And it's a little ironic that they're so particular with language and everything. And they're putting a TVMA show that's pretty much children running around and they're cursing.
Now, was that always TVMA? Or was it initially...
I, you know what? I'm kind of in the same boat as you. I did not know it was. And I thought it was like a joke. I thought it was going to be like a Simpsons-style thing. But it seems like it's like really, really adult.
Except for the here's what always turns me off is I'm kind of like, all right, well, this is cool. This is okay. And then they always go to that one joke where it's just Vince saying,
a bra.
Yeah. It's like, well, that's not a joke. That's not a
There's a clip of the first minute and a half of the show. And literally within the first minute and a half, Vince McMahon calls someone an asshole. And then he says, Like,
oh, wait, look at that. Charlotte's got a new Titantron. That doesn't look like fucking an After Effects template, like all the NXT Titantrons look like.
Well, I don't see it. On the actual Titantron?
Yeah, on the Titantron. It's not just the purple After Effects.
Yeah. Oh, it is new. Interesting. They're playing with it, I guess.
Well, they should. She's like, yeah. You know.
They have all this ability to do great stuff. I mean, I don't mind that these sets are the same now, but they could do a little bit more.
I mean,
I do like Charlotte, though. I do like that they're making her into Rick, you know, 2.0.
Although, geez, Rick probably seen better days, right? You know, between...
I don't understand what happened. He fell, he hit his head, he was bleeding, he was drunk, he wasn't drunk.
Apparently, he was drunk at the airport, at Logan.
Yeah, and then the cops said no, he wasn't.
No, the cops said that he was being treated. The pictures were him being treated for his hand being cut.
And that he was
allowed to get on the plane, for which really all you have to do is swear you're not drunk and say the reason why you're acting all fucked up is because of medication.
Yeah, I'm not drunk.
And let's say, theoretically, Ric Flair might be able to present a police officer with a script bottle to show that, yeah, you know, those that he is actually on Percocets or whatever.
Yeah. I really wish it's Soma's, just to make the story a little better.
Well, it's not Kevin Nash, so we know it's not Soma's.
Yeah, I would like every drug wrestling story to be revolving around Soma's.
Yeah.
Have you ever taken one?
A Soma? No, I have not taken a Soma.
Oh, my God.
Are they great?
Your tongue is numb on them.
Oh, really?
Yeah. You literally, your tongue is the first thing that goes numb. I don't know how these guys are like 38 of them.
Healed in the chat room says, I've heard rumors, nothing from a serious source, that this may be Natty's last match. I don't know if I buy that.
You know, the problem with Natty is that Vince does not really care for her. And Vince thinks that she's really fat and old. So... It may be her final run, and she probably will become a trainer, if anything.
Oh, here he comes.
Brett's going to be here. Brett's here.
There he is, ladies and gentlemen. The best there is, the best there was, the best there ever will be. Brett, the Hitman Hart, fresh off prostate surgery. You know what's so funny is how much they are just running back from NXT. You know, you had Big Cass cut the Hey Arnold promo that almost word for word he did in NXT, and now this was, I forget which takeover, but they ran this exact same gimmick with you know, Charlotte and Natty and Brett and Rick on the outside.
Well, I like that Bret Hart has changed his gimmick and he's no longer a Native American. Navajo Bret Hart is no longer a thing. Bret's not looking good, though. He's walking bad, huh?
I mean, the dude barely beat cancer like a half a month ago, right?
Yeah. Poor guy.
Listen, he is a fighter, and I am very, very confident that he will live to be bitching about Vince's decision-making for many, many decades to come. You know, what's so funny is, like, whenever anybody runs these quotes of Bret Hart saying, like, this is stupid, this is dumb, this is a waste of time, yada, 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 and acting like it's news, like, he was saying the same shit when he was, like, in the ring. Like, he hated Vince's decision-making.
That's always been him. Yeah, that's always been him. He's always been just a curmudgeon. You know,
like, he likes three guys. He likes three guys, and it's ironic that one of the guys that he probably would have and should have liked the most, he fucking hated because they hated each other in Shawn Michaels.
Oh, Hunter. Yeah. I think it's really funny. People are like, oh, well, Bret's bitter and angry, and he's just so bitter. I'm like, you wouldn't be bitter if you were Bret Hart?
He was bitter in his prime. He was bitter, like when he was at the top, and Vince and him and Vince's relationship was at his best, he was bitter.
Yeah. He was just, the whole thing about Bret. Yeah, have you read those shoot interviews where, or watched the shoot interviews where, like, Kevin Nash and a lot of the other guys are like, Bret really thought this is real. Like, Bret Hart would count wins and losses, and it's like a Canadian thing. The Canadians count their wins and losses in wrestling.
Well, you know, you gotta wonder how much of that is just even his like his promotion background, right? Like that.
Yeah.
That if that's something that his dad did, or that's something that they focused on, and by the way, you can't see me, but I do have your camera up, so your lighting.
No, I'm watching the stream. I'm watching the stream right now.
Good.
I see the Matt Mentor. Too sweet.
Indeed. Check that out.
You know, somebody just posted in the IRC, which I can't. I just closed out. It's actually frozen. They said there was a Reddit post that went through everything that Brett went through, and one was that he's bitter because he was supposed to get Hunter's job. That's the job that he was supposed to have. I mean, if you go back like 20 years ago.
I mean,
actually, he was supposed to be Pat Patterson. That's essentially what he was supposed to become, is Pat Patterson.
But also, like, and listen, I mean, there are only so many. Oh, this is great. That slap in the face. So fucking awesome. You know, wrestling's such a weird, carny fucking business, though, right?
Really,
so it's like to say that, like, yeah, he should have had that. It's not like, you know, he's at Disney, right? And he had, like, put in his time or whatever. It's that, like, yeah, at some point, like, somebody had a handshake deal at some point while they were, you know, drinking, you know, Miller Lights, you know, on the road to Tuscaloosa. And, you know, that was the idea that anybody had. But, I mean, you know.
I don't care. I don't care how mainstream wrestling gets. This is still the industry that people shit in each other's luggage, you know?
Yes.
Literally, shit in people's luggage.
Well, so I have between, you know, reading professional wrestling coverage and listening to interviews and knowing a few professional wrestlers, in my kind of renaissance in the art, there's one thing that I never appreciated as a kid that I now appreciate as a functioning adult, and that is that professional wrestlers in general happen to have the egos of athletes and the fragility of actors.
That's absolutely right. Yeah. Yeah.
And that is, you know, obviously when you put those two together in terms of their skill set, that makes a lot of sense. But to know an athlete is to know someone that ego-wise believes they can do anything. You have to.
Yeah.
Like, if you watch any professional sport, the guy on the bubble from going to the minors believes he is the best at anything. You know, he might have.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. I mean, it's the athlete mentality. A lot of my friends played, you know, college ball and basketball. I mean, Division One basketball and football. And these are guys that you would say have a tremendous ego. You know what the difference with wrestling is, though? A football player walks in anywhere, people are going to be like, oh, yeah, he plays for the Giants. That's awesome. A wrestler walks in, and they are constantly, constantly having to defend themselves.
Yeah.
In their minds. Yeah. Listen, in 2016, nobody's going up to a wrestler and be like, hey, you know it's fake, right? It's they have to constantly
but also
the business and who they are and what they do and their legitimacy. And, you know, these are guys, especially back then, like the Bret Hart time. And these were guys that you had to fight in a bar to prove that this is real.
Who is the booker? The booker that if you lost a fight in a bar?
Bill Watts.
If you lost a fight in a bar, you were fired.
Yeah,
like,
you better win.
A, don't fight. B, if you fight, you need to beat the living shit out of them.
But dude, it was like Sing Sing in those locker rooms. You know what I mean? It was like a 500-pound guy that hasn't showered in weeks.
Yeah.
You got the ex-con. You got the guy with the face tattoo. I mean, it really was just a bunch of degenerate carny people. It's amazing to me how it's evolved. But at the heart of it, they're still carny.
But here's the other thing is that now a lot of the athletes, you know, they're sensitive. You know, there's an element of sensitivity to it because it is performance, and you have that performer's, that open underbelly of a performer where it's like, and me and you have it, right? As a podcaster, if somebody points out something about something that you do, a vocal tic or some physical element that you're not comfortable with, like, it hurts. You get fragile to it, right?
You know what bothers me? I like the constructive criticism. Someone's like, hey, Andrew could say a couple less ums. You know, you're being a dick, but I get it. You know, maybe I could do that.
Sure.
But
But it hurts.
It gets exhausting. It does, absolutely. But you know what gets exhausting? Having to explain and defend what I do as a legitimate living. Like,
oh, sure.
Like, oh, what station are you on? And you probably get the same thing. You do it as much as I do. I mean, yeah. we're both making our careers in podcasting.
In podcasting.
I have
in
to
indie podcasting.
Explain to people
yeah.
what I do for a living. And at this point, I just lie and I tell people I'm on XM. Because it's an easier explanation. People are like, oh, what do you do? I'm like, oh, I'm on the radio. Oh, what station? I go, I'm on XM. They just syndicate the show. It's like at 3 o'clock in the morning.
Yeah.
That's all. And I'm done. It's easier for them to grasp that I could make somewhat of a living
yeah.
at 3 a.m. on a station nobody's heard of than to even fathom the concept that
a podcast exists and you listen to it.
You're on the internet?
Yeah.
Yeah, you do this on the internet? Like, it's insane, really. But it's kind of the same thing. You know what I mean? Like you're constantly having to defend what I do.
All right. Well, so this match certainly has been it's hard because easily the person who is probably the most green so far on the card would be, you know, Enzo, but shortly after that would be Charlotte. And this is a match that, like, only by comparison is kind of weak.
Do you think there is going to be I was just thinking about this. Do you think there's going to be any kind of thought or second guessing now that Enzo got hurt like that and it was kind of like a freak accident? But do you think they're going to be like, maybe some of these guys are not ready to come up?
I certainly hope not. I mean,
me too. Yeah.
You know, it's not like, listen, they wrestled every night. You know, they were, yeah, Enzo and Cass were on that same NXT touring schedule that, you know, playing the same six Florida cities, you know, over and over and over and over again. It's not like they don't have a track record of doing it. I mean, that's about as freak gets for him to get caught exactly there on his face that snaps his head back like that. You know, they've wrestled in big arenas before, so it you know.
Is there any updates on coming through?
Not that we've seen. I mean, we're just watching the stuff like you. I assume that they'll probably pipe in as soon as they get anything.
Yeah, we have a connection with the production, somebody in the production truck, and they literally only have what is being said on TV. So there's no like special information that they have right now.
Well, and also that makes sense because as long as he is not out, right, then he's going to get a CAT scan, and they're going to tell him he has a concussion. And as long as he has full control of his extremities, then it's going to be a matter of the concussion protocol.
So Finn Balor tweeted a picture of a bunch of like lawn chairs and water. And he says, getting ready out to lay back for payback. So he's posting that he is at home.
That's a bit of a botch. I mean, who knows? I mean, listen, he was part of those NXT tapings, so.
Yeah, he has a month taped already, so he doesn't really need to be there.
I mean, it does raise the question, why did they not move the championship on the first week of the television tapings?
That's a great question, right? Yeah, why wouldn't they do that? Why would they not? I guess it's the anything could happen mentality, you know?
I mean,
wow,
maybe
that's the botch I got. I guess like, I just caught
oh,
up to
oh,
it.
Oh, the Hunikan run outside.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Rick's looking sober.
I mean, listen, one of these days, yeah, I remember listening to a Ross report once, and this was like before they wound up putting Rick back on TV, but they were rumored to be doing it. And he said, you know, Rick's just got a lot going on. You got to wonder whether or not it's smart to put him on the road all the time.
Who said that, Ross?
Ross.
Yeah. That's awesome.
And, you know, it's funny. You listen to interviews and the problem isn't Charlotte. The problem is Rick going out every night with, like, the Usos and all the other guys that want to party all night.
See, I think in their weird minds, they're like, oh, let's keep Rick on the road because it keeps him a little grounded. But I think Rick's been, you know, habitually drunk for the last 35 years.
I mean, listen, he certainly has the wreckage to prove it. So, listen, I want to give fair credit. Healed in the chat room said before and says again, it's better for Balor to have 6 seconds of him losing on Twitter than losing an entire match on television.
Yeah.
But, like, it didn't hurt Sami Zayn to lose. It didn't hurt Kevin Owens to lose. It didn't hurt, like it doesn't hurt you to lose in the right spot.
No, I mean, you eventually always have to lose. They said the reason why he didn't lose at the pay-per-view is because they don't want Demon Balor to lose. But I don't think that's the case. I think they had plans and this was it, and they decided to maybe move stuff up a little earlier. I don't think they're as organized as we think they are when it comes to booking.
And specifically like, organized between the two, because it is two totally different operations. Where NXT ends is, you know, Vince calling Hunter and saying, I want this person. And then that's it. And then NXT just has to work out whatever they're doing. This is not a cohesive unit.
No. And even if it was, like, they have ideas. Like, they have, like, 6 month ideas. But that doesn't mean that they're going to stick to it. If Vince wakes up and decides, no, I'm gonna jump ahead by 2 months, that's what happens.
Yeah. Heald says Zayn didn't lose clean. He lost hurt, and Owens was a heel. But Zayn being hurt was only happenstance. Like, if Zayn was healthy, he would have lost to Owens.
If Zayn was healthy, he would have lost
time.
To Owens?
Yeah, the second time.
Yeah.
He got hurt popping out his shoulder in the Cena U.S. Open match.
That's a beautiful moonsault.
Or maybe he wouldn't. Maybe he would have got the title back. I don't know. I mean, I don't have any fucking inside.
Okay, so here's a question for you. Do you think it's a good idea to bring some of these guys back for one-off angles?
In NXT or in WWE?
No, in NXT.
Of course it is.
Like, I wouldn't mind seeing Kevin Owens go down there for a month. And, he could still do both TVs, but he goes down for taping and leads up to a pay-per-view.
Yeah, I want a lot of the guys that don't get time. I want, I think it did Zack Ryder a world of good to go down to NXT. I mean,
Bo Dallas should go down there.
Don't get me started. I had to yell at you on your own podcast Bo Dallas.
Did.
Because, that's absolutely incorrect to do anything but to say Bo Dallas is a national treasure. And if you look at his run in NXT, it shows you. Like, that man is a star. Oh, no. Oh, no, Charlotte, but the sharpshooter. Oh, Canada hangs its head in shame, Maggle.
I heard the bell ring.
Oh, my God. They're running the screw job?
Hold on.
They're running the screw job. The Chicago screw job.
How are you so ahead of me?
Oh, we got right in the middle of the ring.
Uh-oh, Brett's going back to WCW.
Can he just get up there and just, like,
finger? Oh, like, Brett and Nate are working it now. A sharpshooter. A sharpshooter for Brett.
Oh, here it is.
Double sharpshooters. Brett's going to see if he can remember how to do it. Oh, the flares. The flares. Yes! I'm marking out, bro. They're all tapping. They're tapping in stereo, Maggle.
Oh, because it was Little Nate as the ref.
Yep.
You know what? Someone pointed that out on Twitter before. He's like, Little Nate is... Oh, nice punch. Oh, my God. I'm here right now.
I'm marking out, bro. I'm marking out.
And flip. He's like, okay, left leg over, right leg back. Okay. So this is going to continue into a story now. Who rung the bell? Who was there?
It can. I mean, or it's just, I mean, the only problem is corrupting Little Nate like that. Unless they're moving Little Nate off, like, active referee stuff, but...
That's interesting. I mean, I didn't see that coming. You know what's funny sometimes? So Rich does a live tweeting and I do live tweeting, and yeah, we will literally tweet the same exact thing. Because, you know, he's doing whatever. Like, it really happens, but every now and then, it's we both literally just tweet a Chicago screw job.
That is great.
Yeah, I'm curious on how they're going to explain this tomorrow. Interesting. I like it.
Well, at least it gives you something to think about.
Yeah. Yeah, something different.
So here's my thing. They need to get rid of Extreme Rules.
Yeah, it's a dumb pay-per-view.
Well, just because, like, you can't... Don't say Extreme Rules when you can't do the kind of stuff that we knew was extreme.
You know what I want them to do? You can still not do half the stuff. Take Extreme Rules and have it in, like, at the Hammerstein Ballroom every year.
Well, they're not going to do that. They're going to have it in an arena.
Yeah, but that's what I want to see. I want to see a small arena, smaller crowd, lower, you know, dim the lights like you do in a house show, and call that Extreme Rules. I don't think we need these gimmicks anymore.
Well, I mean, I don't worry about... I mean, like, you just can't have too many gimmicks. Like...
Yeah.
And when you do them, like, actually, like build up to them, like... You know, where they had such a shitty Survivor Series this year, and then like 2 weeks later had four ready-made four-person factions, right?
Yeah. Yeah, they missed it by a couple of weeks, huh?
Yeah, because it was like the next week that the League of Nations formed, right?
Yeah. Hey, I'm getting the high sign from the baby.
All right, well, here we go. Ladies and gentlemen, making his exit, Andrew Zarian, Matt Men, the podcast you need to subscribe to it. We'll be watching your tweets as you go along. Thank you so much for joining us, and we'll talk to you later, man.
By the
way,
I love it when you're on the show, and we got to have you on again.
Please, whenever you need me, you know I'm there.
I know, and you're always unbelievable. So,
you're gonna make me blush.
Yeah, whenever you're on, you're great. You're wonderful.
Peace out, brother. Talk to you.
All right, guys. See you guys.
Oh, look at that! Skype mutes all the other audio. Look at that. So wow, so we're doing the decision. Look at the billionaire strut right there. Oh shit, wait, if Treehouse Vince was on my Hearthstone stream, then I missed it. All right, here we go. He's going to make the right decision, I guarantee it. And hopefully fire you, Byron. Vince McMahon in the middle of the ring in all of his glory. Vince, bring back the draft, the sign right behind him. Fucking the most energetic old motherfucker I've ever seen, man. A CM Punk chant. All right, enough. He actually likes CM Punk. Apparently, CM's beef was with Triple H.
Monday Night Raw.
Vince and CM are both insomniacs. They apparently liked each other.
Matter of fact, there have been some 1,196 additions and counting. Glad you said that. One of the reasons why Raw has been so successful is because it's been able to morph, it's been able to change through the times. It's reinvented itself over and over again.
Now,
I'm wondering how long you can go with this thing.
Oh, he acknowledges it. I love when he says the things that he makes Michael Cole say.
Raw's been able to morph through the years. One of the reasons why it has, we reinvent Raw all the time. In order to reinvent Raw, well, there's certain eras certain iterations and eras that have occurred. Matter of fact, one of my favorite eras of Monday Night Raw would be the Attitude Era.
Uh-oh.
But now we have a new era in Monday Night Raw. We need someone who has new leadership skills. Someone who has a great personal set of ethics. Someone who has great business acumen. Someone who has a vision as to where we should be going. This person indeed needs to be not just a great business person, but a great person of personal ethics. So we're at a decision here. Who should be running Monday Night Raw? Should it be my son Shane?
Well, way to cut to the bimbos in the crowd brushing their hair back.
Or should it be my daughter Stephanie? I don't always appreciate your point of view, by the way. So please welcome, without further ado, my daughter Stephanie.
Uh-oh, and here we go. Stephanie McMahon making her way to the ring, dressed in a very, very smart suit jacket, low-cut white blouse, and tight leather pants. The new GM is Dixie Carter. Is Jim Cornette. I do really, really. I mean, it's hard for Vince to be bad guy anymore.
Isn't she beautiful?
Like, he can be tweener, but he just has to be him. Because we all know he's the boss.
You know, first and foremost, I would like to just thank all of you for your outpouring.
Oh, just getting a boot out of the building to Stephanie. Know how to work him. Hachi machi.
Show some respect.
Never mind. I'm sorry. Did I say something so stupid like Vince can't be a bad guy? Because I love him. I'm an idiot. He's a genius. All right.
Their support, and I certainly don't want their compassion or their sympathy, because I would rather be feared or respected than felt sorry for. Because I am a leader, and all of you know it.
I'll tell you what. The pop for fucking WWE Here Comes the Money is going to be decimating.
We saw the Divas Revolution become a woman's evolution. We saw the debut of superstars like The Shield, Dean Ambrose, Seth Rollins, the WWE World Heavyweight Champion, Roman Reigns, Kevin Owens, the Tag Team Champions, The New Day, Becky Lynch, the boss, Sasha Banks, the women's champion, Charlotte Flair, and even tonight's number one contender, AJ Styles.
Stephanie making a very good case for herself.
Accomplishment under the authority's leadership was the launch of the WWE Network, taken from a germ of an idea into 1.8 million subscribers, a network created.
That's a pretty good number. There are 2 million.
To give you the value that you demanded and that you so richly deserve. Now, you may not agree with all of my decisions. I may not be the most popular candidate here, but there is no.
No, healed. As far as the WWE Network goes, they have to report that legitimately for their shareholders. So that's probably legit.
Monday Night Raw is because, well, he's a man, and his myopic and misogynistic.
Wait, hold on. Is Stephanie cutting a promo as a R/ the red pill heel?
Going got tough. What did Shane McMahon do? What did he do? He abandoned for 7 years. That's a leader. That's someone you want leading this company. What's going to stop Shane from doing that all over again? And besides that, Dad, Shane lost his match to The Undertaker at WrestleMania. He was so desperate to defeat The Undertaker, he leapt off the top of the Hell in the Cell. And while that move was quite spectacular...
Stephanie actually cutting the promo that should have been cut the day after WrestleMania when it came to this Shane McMahon shit.
And Dad, I know that you don't want to hear this or be reminded of this, but Shane, the only way that he got his foot back in this door was by blackmailing you. Shane doesn't respect you and the global brand that you've created. He stabbed you in the back and he spit in your face. And I cannot imagine someone lacking in intelligence and integrity running Monday Night Raw. Therefore, Dad, you need the savviest, smartest, most experienced leader that you can possibly find, and that leaves only one choice.
There's actually another choice.
Yeah.
Shane McMahon.
That is an ovation, ladies and gentlemen, for Shane O'Mac. Now making his way to the ring in blue jeans and some high top Air Jordans. Sneaker watch.
The big show right here at Pay-Per-View Backlash in Chicago. That's going to be nothing compared to his fall from grace tonight.
So, I mean, so here's the question. I mean, this is a legitimate promo of consequence, right?
It was perfect.
Like, Vince set it up very much evocative of his, we believe that the idea of good guys and bad guys is simply passé.
I mean, Shane's going to have a heck of an argument to make himself.
Listen to that. That is a big ovation. Shane is over, my friends, over.
That's all Shane does. They absolutely eat it up. That's all they want. Every time.
What's up, Chicago?
Shane milking it.
Exactly. Well, normally I wouldn't come out here, and I don't really like to talk about myself. But since that's what we're doing here, trying to vie for who controls Monday Night Raw, that's what I need to do. So, therefore, Stephanie, let me ask you a question. How many headlines have you and your husband received over the years about what a very good job you guys are doing running Monday Night Raw?
Oh, look at this direct internet pandering.
Allow me just to point out...
Allow me to let you know that I subscribe to R Squared Circle.
Let's see. Fox Sports. NXT stars and Shane McMahon have completely revitalized WWE Raw. Let's go to another. Oh, SN Sporting News. What we learn on WWE Raw, wrestling is once again cool. Five signs that Monday Night Raw is changing for the better.
Uh-oh, shit's getting meta, bro.
Don't forget this one. Shane McMahon is the right choice to become WWE's new...
Shane is Falcon Arrow.
Next, please. Shane McMahon running WWE Raw is best for business. And finally, from Rolling Stone, WWE Raw, Shane McMahon soars. Now, you talked about the WWE Network, and let's give credit where credit is due. That is the brainchild of one man, and that is you, so much respect deserved. But the 1.8 million subscribers that you're talking about, well, you got about 18,000 of them here tonight.
Acknowledging the crowd.
But you're trying to take credit for the 1.8 million. The only people that could take credit for that is the actual 1.8 million subscribers that belong to the WWE Network. There was, dare I say, a jump around WrestleMania 32, however. And WrestleMania 32 was an amazing event, AT&T Stadium, like you said. But there perhaps was one match in particular that everyone
Ice Worm says, I doubt all 18,000 are subscribers.
In.
No, it's 17,999 sharing one dude's account.
Happens to be standing in this very ring.
Your humility is inspiring, Shane.
But also to answer your question, okay? Let's get into something. So you talked about my departure.
Germ24, WWE's ratings are at the level WCW was at before it went under. Those are not apples to oranges pairings.
Thank you. Yes, I do. Thank you.
This has got to be such a proud moment, though, for Vince to watch the two of these guys just fucking rocket in this crowd.
Let's talk about my departure 7 years ago. You don't know a lot of things about that, but I will tell you one thing that I haven't said yet. Basically, my voice was being heard. I had a different direction that I thought the company should go into, and that resulted in irreconcilable differences between the chairman and myself.
Oh, work shoot, ladies and gentlemen. That quiets the crowd.
But that left an enormous void, a void that you and your husband filled. And instead of catapulting the company where everyone wanted to go and huge success and fresh matchups and new talent and making it hot, what you guys did is you just put your own poison all the way through that. It was such a big ego play for you guys that literally your venomous spew went from the corporate tower to the locker room to every arena in the WWE, period.
Man, this is Shane doing the full Back to the Future pitch.
And you nearly burned the thing all the way down to the ground. So I came back to ensure once again the future, not only for my kids, but for your daughters, for all of them, and eventually their kids and their kids' kids, etc., etc. That's why I returned to the WWE.
Buck R.I., a work shoot, so he's basically saying things that are true, but doing it in a storyline. A Back to the Future thing, he's saying, what if we could go back to when I left? What if we could erase the last 7 years?
I ask that you listen to me. And you don't actually have
Which basically means the PG era.
Because I'll say this. They all speak for me.
Shane. Getting this crowd riled up. Do y'all want change? Do y'all want hope?
All right, enough of that. Enough of that crap. Stop it.
Well, all night. If I may, just because I'm having so much fun with this, and this may be my last night, those that would not want to see Stephanie McMahon run Raw? Shane McMahon.
Okay, shenanigans now.
I love it, Michael. I love it.
In all due respect, Shane, Stephanie makes a really a lot of good points. I mean,
and the thing is, Dad, too. I mean, the one thing that Shane does have over me is likability. But business is not run by popularity, and I'm just glad that Shane finally has the respect for you to make this decision.
Stephanie makes a lot of good points. Shane, come on. You lost the match to The Undertaker. You shouldn't even be standing in the ring right now. The only reason you are is because the night after Raw, you were pretty classy. You went out and you said goodbye. You sort of upstaged me. I said, try running Raw, cause you're gonna fall flat on your face. And you didn't. I decided, all right, let's try another week. And you were okay at that one, and maybe even some would say better than okay.
Healed, what's left on the show would be, is it only AJ Reigns? Yeah, it might end early.
I don't listen to anybody except me.
Well, that's a work shoot. I don't listen to anybody except me.
It's not about you, not about Stephanie, not about them. Tonight is about me. It's about what I want, not what you really want. It's about what I want. And here's what I want.
Brand split. Here we go.
Figuratively speaking, I want blood. I want blood. I want to see you both slit each other's throat. I want to see you both disembowel each other. That's what I want to see. Or there could be a collaborative effort of some kind that might be the best for Raw, might even be best for the family. I don't know. All I know is this is going to be entertaining because you both have equal say and you both are running Monday Night Raw. Go figure it out.
Well, that's not a brand split.
Oh, my God. Stephanie and Shane can't stand it.
Oh, jeez, man. That was a fucking innie of a boner, huh?
Stephanie and Shane.
So now the authority is Shane and Steph. So buttons.
So how do Stephanie and Shane get along? Do they work together? Or do they, quote, slit each other's throats? Man just put gasoline on the fire and lit it. And threw a pack of TNT on top of it.
Heald says, so basically fuck SmackDown. Sure. Shane now reaching out for a handshake. Stephanie shakes his hand.
Wow. Shane and Stephanie are both in charge of Monday Night Raw. I cannot wait to tomorrow night in St. Louis.
Worse than Column A and Cleopatra.
Well, you know, we have an all-star panel.
See, now here's the thing, though. If they wanted to do that, then, like, why not have them step up, like, hey, listen, not only do you not belong on Raw, you don't belong in the company. Because here's the thing, they've worked well together in the past, like, storyline-wise. Maybe not successfully. Remember, they ran the invasion against WWF. Oh, hey, shit. By the way, do yourself a favor. Go on Reddit or go look up a bunch of pictures from Jerry Lawler on his old website back in the 90s. He used to just put up, like, fucking damn near porno pictures of his girlfriend, Kat, on the internet just randomly. Like, he literally just took, like, naked pictures of her where she was, like, strategically, like, covering nipples. Like, dude, Jerry got down. His wife, I mean girlfriend, I don't know when they got married, but they were like dating and then they got married.
What a night it's been. We knew it was going to be big. I want to talk about finally Kevin Owens vanquishing his rival Sami Zayn clean in the middle of the ring. And then that maniac Zayn, that egotistical, self-centered, sore loser, costing Cesaro the championship and then getting another pop-up powerbomb for his troubles. I could watch that all night.
Buck?
Oh, man, Dean Ambrose, what I did, got his respect from Chris Jericho. Dean Ambrose and Aretha Franklin, R-E-S-P-E-C-T.
Respect.
Respect,
get
brother.
That respect. Well, it was actually earlier tonight on the Payback kickoff show that we got our first bit of action in not one, but two incredible matchups.
Yeah, it all began with Dolph Ziggler versus Baron Corbin in a Byron. This is the matchup we've actually been waiting for.
Yeah, by the way, I guess they put Baron Corbin, Dolph Ziggler on the pre-show to give the tag team more match up, or sorry, the tag team matchup more time, and yet it was not needed because the tag team matchup got fucked due to injury. She debuted after they were married. She was like 25 years younger. Okay, well, yeah, pardon me. Yeah, there we go. If you are in the chat room, then you will be able to see the post that Ice Worm put up about the cat.
Setting in on the big guy Ryback.
Yeah, frustration would cost Ryback. Did everything he could to take Kalisto out of the mix. But the key word that we always seem to see its head come back up is resiliency. And resiliency is what allowed Kalisto to deliver Salido del Sol and hold on.
Although I'll tell you what, you know, after Enzo goes out, you know, with a head injury that puts him down, like the Salido del Sol looks a lot more devastating. There is that picture that Heel just put up in the chat room of the Big Show looking like a big fabulous drag queen. All right, let's go ahead and take a look at what is happening here on Twitter. I don't know exactly how positive it will be. And here we go. Stephanie and Shane both running Raw is smart. Why? Because they can blame decisions that hardcores hate on Steph and the ones that they love on Shane. Smart move. The ever-positive Aubrey Citizen. By the way, everybody needs to watch Aubrey Citizen's Straight Shoot, which will come on right after this. They got Shayna Blazer, the MMA star who is now doing professional wrestling. Aubrey does probably the best wrestling talk show in the game. He is so smart. He gets great guests. Everybody should go support him. Batman Podcast, guys, we love you. You fool us and make us better. Oh, whatever. Ample time devoted to the McMahon dysfunctional family saga. Major storyline is Co-GMs on Raw. I'm all for new. The arena made a killing on popcorns and guns during that segment. Yeah, McMahon, Civil War at SummerSlam. I guess that makes sense. And here randomly is a shot of Johnny Manziel and Riff Raff. I mean, the thing is, like, in the moment, it's kind of hard. If you're upset that Shane isn't running Raw on his own or some brand split didn't happen, good. Hashtag, you're getting worked, bro. Hard not to say.
To congratulate you on being the new WWE World Heavyweight Champion.
Heel, the McMahon decision was longer than any match. No! Wasn't longer than Zayn Owens. AJ Styles, easily the most athletic, third in command guy at your local car mechanic.
Having the match of my life is what I do. And at Payback, having the match of my life is going to make me champion.
Terror Rising is my favorite wrestler. Oh, come on, man. All right, I'm going to grab myself a fork, and I'm going to eat during this match, just so y'all know.
Hey, that's Gallows and Anderson.
This is a land of opportunity.
That's AJ Styles' friends. Oh, my goodness, Roman Reigns in trouble.
We're going to make the most out of ours.
I had nothing to do with Gallows or Anderson's attack.
You expect me to believe that?
Absolute destruction of the Usos by Gallows and Anderson.
I know those are your boys. I know you brought them here.
I don't need my friends to beat you for your title.
I don't think they're done.
Bring all your friends. It won't matter. One versus all.
And Roman Reigns coming to the aid of his cousins, the Usos.
AJ, you're not fooling anyone.
But the numbers game too much for Roman Reigns. Styles making his way down here.
I don't care what Roman Reigns thinks.
Oh, man, Superman punch from Reigns to Styles.
One versus all.
And Roman Reigns fighting back.
And at Payback, he will not be calling me a liar.
Is this collusion?
You've never beaten me. And you never will.
And we are moments away from our WWE World Heavyweight Championship match between Roman Reigns and AJ
Gallows
Styles.
Looks like a bald Kevin Nash. Not a untrue statement.
WWE superstar Enzo Amore. We want to take you back to the beginning of Payback when Amore and his partner Cass were taking on the Vaudevillains in a tag team match. And right there, you see Enzo Amore face first into the second rope and then collapsing in a heap outside the ring.
Yeah, you see this in slow motion right there, almost a whiplash effect.
And then you see his head hitting the mat on the way down. Enzo Amore was out for a matter of time. In fact, doctors, medical personnel, EMTs had to come out to ringside and put Enzo on a stretcher and stretcher him out of the arena. We have news now from the medical center here in Chicago who treated Enzo Amore. He is still at the hospital, but he has been diagnosed as having a concussion. However, all other tests have come back negative. So we hope that bodes well for Enzo Amore. Again, a concussion suffer here tonight from Enzo Amore. We hope to have updates on both WWE.com and Monday Night Raw tomorrow night.
So, I mean, all right. He's got a concussion. And now it's a matter of when they're going to let him work again. Is that a real injury or is it part of the show? You can't trust anyone. No. That's a real injury. That is a real injury. You don't end a match that early if it's not real.
Talking about a new era starting. Comiskey Park right here in Chicago.
You think they'll push Cass as a single with Enzo being his manager until he's healed? I mean, it depends on what it is. It depends on his concussion history. It depends on how comfortable they are. They're probably going to have him get the same kind of desk that they made Daniel Bryan get. It would be very sad if he does not wrestle again.
It was 2 years ago, May 3rd, 2014, AJ Styles won the IGWP Championship in Japan. He hopes to win the one championship that has eluded him in his career.
So here we go. This match is probably getting it started almost at dead on 10:30 East Coast. What do AJ's gloves say when you put them together? P1, because he is the phenomenal one. Healed. Yeah, no, they've actually mentioned the IWGP title a bunch, specifically with Brock Lesnar and AJ Styles. I'm sure they'll mention it with Finn Balor.
Championship and dared anyone to step up to the plate and knock him down. And the guy means that Roman Reigns is the WWE World Heavyweight Champion, the standard bearer in WWE.
Yeah, and this Chicago crowd, like a lot of the WWE universe, some say all of them, love to boo Roman Reigns.
Well, Roman Reigns has said, John, I'm not a good guy. I'm not a bad guy. I'm the guy.
Yes, he is. So who does the gay community root for in this match?
Retired today, Jock Berger. Reminds you a lot of Roman Reigns. Didn't care if anybody liked him.
I don't know. Probably still AJ. He's still a dream.
That's one thing you can't argue, John, the effectiveness of that man. What Roman Reigns has accomplished to be the top dog in the WWE.
Hey, what is so great about this? Everyone is on their feet. You can love him, you can hate him, you can boo him, you can cheer him, but everybody here...
I mean, the problem with TNA is that, like, I don't blame them for not mentioning it. Because, like, what does it do for the champion? Like, what does it do to mention somebody's history in TNA?
The following contest, scheduled for one fall, is for the WWE World Heavyweight Championship. Introducing first the challenger.
Whatever happened to Air Paris? You know he's got talent. He was Air Styles. It was Air Styles and Air Paris.
His opponent.
So I think we can agree there's not a brand split right now, right? That maybe Civil War at SummerSlam.
He is the WWE World Heavyweight Champion, Roman Reigns.
Had the opportunity to talk to AJ Styles a little bit earlier today, and Styles said that he thought when he won the IWGP Championship that it would be the last gold he'd ever hold in his career until the opportunity to get here.
Roman almost seemed like trying to psych out AJ Styles a moment ago. And whatever last minute psychological edge he can get.
Roman sucks chant going up from the what is in the Rose? Is this the Rosemont? No. What is the building they're in now? Air something center. United Center? Is it the United Center? Where are they? What is the Allstate Arena?
Call you phenomenal, but once you get in the ring with Roman Reigns like AJ Styles is doing, he's going to feel the explosiveness and the athleticism.
So if you're going to compare this match to anything, you got to compare it to Fastlane. Roman versus Daniel Bryan, right? That's the last time that he wrestled someone with this level of skill, this level of over, this kind of size and body type. Although AJ works far more of an aerial style than Daniel ever worked.
WrestleMania, the night he defeated Triple H in front of 101,000 in Dallas.
And one thing that AJ Styles knows, they just found out if he doesn't know, you can't match Roman.
Yeah, Fastlane 2015.
AJ Styles won a fatal four-way match to earn this opportunity tonight. Side headlock on the champion.
I mean, here's the dirty little secret in wrestling is that, like, Roman wrestles, like, really good big matches. In fact, I would say the worst match was him and Triple H. He worked a great match against Brock. He worked a great match against Daniel Bryan. I have high hopes for
this match. We'd be seeing AJ Styles challenging for the WWE World Heavyweight Championship.
Lands on his feet, hit right to the hamstring of Roman Reigns. Styles burst on the scene 3 months ago with the Royal Rumble match. It's been an incredible 3 months for Styles. Opportunity to cap off what would be a Cinderella story.
I mean, Heald says Roman is the perfect told what to do wrestler. That means every face is told what to do. No, Icerum says, do you think Triple H Reigns was bad because Reigns was going over? No. I don't think it was bad. I just think it was the weakest of his big matches. I really liked his Brock match at the WrestleMania before.
In that case, power works. Styles looking to use his quickness here.
Oh!
I mean, Styles' initial foray is starting to work.
And the well-directed kicks from Styles. That smile on the face of AJ Styles.
Problem with AJ, man, it's like that dude looks doofy. He just has a doofy look to him, man. He might be the greatest wrestler on the planet, but when you just look at him, you just think that he's like that dude who's too excited to be at a Braves game in July.
Let's go. And that's when you actually get comfortable and things start slowing down again.
AJ Styles was not going to step back from the fight. He did say that he'd step on Superman's cape.
I mean, Heald makes a point. Roman has always had elite partners in the Shield that created the matches for him. Singles matches against Roman, against Bryan, who can pull four stars out of a broom, and Brock, who can just say, let's fight. I don't think it's that simple, man. Like, I will criticize Roman for a million different things, but, like, you have to give him credit for the fact that it takes two to tango to make a great match. And he made a great match against Brock Lesnar, who has had shitty matches against better people than Roman. And he had a great match against Bryan, who, like, yes, he can do a lot of the work, but it takes two to tango.
AJ Styles wants a wrestling match.
Like, Daniel Bryan cannot have a four-star match with the great Khali.
AJ daring Roman Reigns to get out of the ring. Again, AJ Styles has been through battles all over the world. He knows what he's doing out there. He knows how to play games with the best of them. And just like that, Styles with a kick to the ribs and out the side of the head of Roman Reigns. And AJ Styles stomping away at the champion.
Wait, Heald said Cena did. Cena's one of the best professional wrestlers of the modern era.
Stunning Reigns.
It was the one that suckered Roman Reigns in.
And Roman Reigns with a shoulder tackle. And that knocks AJ clear out of the ring.
All the way out of the ring.
Reestablished dominance.
FLS Carnage points out it's 2016. We like Cena now. Fair point.
It's not meant to knock somebody out. It's just meant to show somebody their power. That's what Roman Reigns is establishing right now. And AJ Styles just felt it firsthand.
AJ Styles realizes how important tonight is. John, you know better than anyone. You don't often get an opportunity at the WWE World Heavyweight.
Tell you what, though, this is really, really good. To begin the match, drain a little bit of that hot energy out of the crowd.
Very similar to AJ Styles.
Build a nice little palette.
Come back. You've got to capitalize on it. Styles has won championships all over the world, but it's kind of like Herschel Walker in the USFL. You knew he's the best running back in the world, but you couldn't prove it until he got in the NFL.
AJ doing a great job, man, selling Roman's power.
But you're going to find out right now how good he really is.
I mean, that's the problem, is that, like, they really just, like, someone put something up on Squared Circle that I thought was a very, very good point about his match, Roman's match with Miz on SmackDown, that the problem isn't, like, the problem in Roman's matches is that he's so fucking powerful, or at least we've been told to, and he looks powerful, that, like, when he gets his ass kicked by The Miz for 5 minutes, like, it's just, it's boring because we don't buy that The Miz is going to win. And it's stupid because why is The Miz beating up Roman? Roman should just dominate everybody. He went head-to-head with Brock Lesnar. That is an insane clothesline. Roman is strong. Very strong. Very strong, Roman.
Roman Reigns rolling him up. There's the power of Reigns. Little display. That was to send a message. Roman Reigns did that to make a statement.
That's good, man. Tell me you're not into this. I swear to God, tell me you're not into this.
Reigns wants AJ to feel the power.
This is great.
Roman Reigns wants AJ to know exactly how explosive he is.
Like, arrogant champion lifting on a one count so he can powerbomb him again and then not pinning him.
Roman Reigns just looked down on him and started bad-mouthing Styles.
What works against an ordinary person doesn't work against Roman Reigns.
Sit down, powerbomb.
Isn't just about
come
power.
On, Ice Worm. Listen, he's not going to turn heel. He's going to be a tweener.
And by the end of that match,
just learn to love that. Learn that you were half right.
Everything Triple H had at this year's WrestleMania. Styles thinking here. Styles, stay down, that's what he's saying. AJ gonna fight back to his feet though. And now Roman Reigns looking to lock it.
Here we go. Here comes the comeback. They're definitely wrestling Roman as the heel.
That's what Styles has to do to survive and potentially win this match. Watch this. Styles caught it. Flush. Reigns stunned. His counter, that explosiveness and that athleticism of Roman Reigns with innovation and quickness. Reigns,
I mean, he'll. Yeah, I think the test for Reigns will be going against someone that isn't a Hall of Famer. Like, the test for what? If he's the best wrestler ever? He's not. He'll fail that. The test of can he be an effective champion? Then keep putting him with fucking Hall of Famers. Keep putting him with fucking great people. They got plenty of them on the goddamn roster. Oh, I'll tell you what. If Roman, or sorry, if AJ gave Roman the GTS right now, that crowd would have ended the match because he would have flooded the ring with jizz.
See AJ favoring that lower back. AJ Styles says winners find a way to win. Losers make excuses and give up.
AJ Styles is right.
How bad do you want it?
One of the reasons he's been so successful all over the world. It's also why Roman Reigns has been so successful right here in WWE.
Oh, look at him. Roman Reigns caught Styles as he came up on the top rope. Styles, though, elbows and knees.
Now, great resourcefulness from AJ Styles.
Styles spins around. Look out, rolls through. Looking for a
calf crusher. Calf crusher in the middle of the ring.
Roman Reigns is feeling it. Trying to pull himself to the rope and can't quite get there. Now to the other side. It's going to force the break. AJ couldn't quite get it fully locked in.
That's good. That's
that
good.
Same leg, that left leg, because AJ Styles kicks better with his right foot that was getting knotted up with that hamstring with those kicks earlier in the match.
If he can be the main guy, because there's never been a successful main guy in the WWE that can't drag a good match out of a poor wrestler. I mean, sure. Also, they've never been in the position that they're in right now where they have, like, the top world's talent. You can find 11 opponents for Roman Reigns to run 11 different pay-per-view angles that are all fucking amazing. That spot ruled. That spot ruled. Everybody look at that spot ruled. That spot's great. AJ coming off the top rope and running Roman through the table with a punch. That's so great. I like it a bunch. That spot ruled. That spot ruled. That is awesome. That spot ruled. That's fucking dope, though. That's dope.
To remove the target.
That's great. And that's why it's important that he sold how dominant he was before. This is a good match, you guys. Can we just like the Roman that we have? Can we just understand that there is a worth? I swear I'm asking you specifically. Can we just understand that there's a worth to the Roman we have? Oh, no. No. I mean, listen, it kind of makes sense when you've already had somebody go out on a stretcher on a head injury to end it on a punch to the face. Oh, no, Shane! Shane!
Come here, that may have been how things ended in the old era, but in the new era, that is not how a championship match is going to be defined.
So this is old right fucking now, school.
This match will restart with no countouts.
Yeah, good call.
I like that call.
Great call.
I'm sure the champ Roman Reigns is going to, but nonetheless, Roman Reigns is always up for a fight. But look at him, Roman Reigns still suffering the effects.
Yeah, Roman Reigns has not gotten to his feet at all.
With no countouts, which now means fuckery is in the cards.
AJ Styles got 3 seconds away from winning the championship. Cover him, AJ.
Roman Reigns can't move. AJ Styles.
Oh, no. Phoenix Splash. Phoenix Splash.
From the top rope, AJ Styles and Roman Reigns wisely crawling.
Oh. Oh, my God. I thought I was going to go for the Phoenix Splash. That was going
to
go crazy.
Roman Reigns has not been a champion long, but that was a ring veteran move.
And so is that.
And Styles forearm out to forearm. Roman Reigns has been stunned. Still feeling the effects of going through the announce table moments ago. AJ Styles, the challenger. Pele kick! Is that enough to win the championship?
He'll cap it off.
What is... I guess AJ believes that he wasn't going to be able to put...
I mean, we're going to see the Bullet Club, right?
So he's going to put him in the position for one more final big move.
Or the spiral... the spiral tap.
Not the Phoenix Splash. My bad. I got my marks.
Fucking moves mixed up.
What's he going to do here? We're about to find out. 450! Oh, Roman Reigns got his knees up. And he caught Styles for the victory. Styles stays in it at 2.5.
Talk about a plan almost backfiring for AJ Styles.
Roman Reigns has gone into survival mode. We thought this match would play.
No, it wouldn't be forearm to spear. It'd be forearm to Superman punch. There's going to be a riot if Roman Reigns gets this. Spoiler alert, he's going to get it. I swear, listen, don't think about the reins you don't have. Think about the reins you have and understand that there is a worth to him. Just tell me there's a worth to him. This is fun. Are you not having fun? I am having fun. I know you're having fun.
Moments ago. And the official, I believe that. That's right. The official's going to call for the bell. He's called for disqualification because of a low blow. That was a low blow.
Here is your winner by disqualification, AJ.
And now here comes Stephanie. Here comes Stephanie. Not to be one up by bro.
As usual, my brother missed something, and payback isn't going to end like that. I order this match be restarted until there is a clear, definitive winner, and it will be no disqualification.
Bullet Club. Bullet Club. Right. Let's go.
This matchup is now no count out and no disqualification.
Oh, mark it out. I'm marking out, man. I'm marking out. This is great.
Styles the worst for wear, but he's still fighting back. Styles forearms and chops, and AJ Styles and the champion out. Put Styles up on the top rope.
Oh, that's great. This is all great. I love every minute of this. Wrestling's fun. I've been drinking. I love it, Michael.
It seems like Roman Reigns has new life.
Roman Reigns still limping around in that bad leg. Courtesy of AJ Styles, who's now bounced off the steps. Reigns having a couple standing for a second there. Oh, now set right off the Spanish announce table. And now a
kick driving Styles on top of the barricade. Now set out into the crowd.
Remember, we're going out of the crowd. I swear to God, if CM Punk's in there drinking a Pepsi,
yeah, I think that's absolutely favorite.
This shit is going to go insane.
No rules now. And Roman Reigns is going out after AJ Styles.
Roman Reigns, the one that with the shield ran roughshod all over this entire company. Roman Reigns is at home out here.
Oh, my God.
God damn.
Roman Reigns hit an announce table coming over the barricade?
That was not right.
That's the other thing. The underrated element of Roman Reigns is that, like, he will work stiff, man. He works stiff as fuck with Brock Lesnar. This match is pretty fucking stiff.
We said no disqualification. Might favor Roman Reigns. I think we may have to change our opinion.
Is that an AJ Styles Roman Reigns chant I hear, perchance? Roman's going to get a little over with this Chicago crowd.
AJ Styles sent Roman Reigns up, perhaps going for that phenomenal Superman punch.
Told you, it's Superman punch, not a spear from the top. Kick out, kick out, kick out. Kick out. That looks amazing, though, right? That's some Avenger shit. That's what everybody, like, always, like, Roman. I mean, like, I'm not saying Roman's the best. I'm saying Roman's good for being Roman, right? He's always good for an Avenger spot. Also, I wish he did the drive-by still. I love the drive-by. Bullet Club, Bullet Club, cue the Bullet Club, and we're go for Bullet Club.
That may be the beginning of the end. Styles has no clue where he's at, and Roman Reigns is just going to set up here to put Styles away. Uh-oh. Oh, look who's here. Styles' buddies from Japan, Gallows and Anderson. Remember, no disqualification. The referee can do nothing about them being out here. We've talked about, is there collusion between these two and Styles for weeks now? And now Anderson and Gallows coming right after Roman Reigns.
Yeah, no time for questions. Roman Reigns now is going to deal with it.
See, now the crowd's booing.
The two-on-one assault. And again, the referee is powerless.
Here it comes.
Boot of doom. And that may be it. Roman Reigns may be out. Could be easy pickings for AJ Styles.
AJ Styles.
I don't know if AJ realizes what happened, but.
Well, what he does see is the champion who's in trouble. If Styles can drag himself back in the ring, he could win the championship right here.
This is pretty good, man. This is pretty good. This is pretty good.
Pull himself back up. He was hit with two straight Superman punches.
Come on now. Where are we going to go?
Before you see Gallows and Anderson interfere. AJ Styles, he's setting up for that phenomenal forearm.
I don't know if he's got enough to deliver the phenomenal forearm.
If he does.
And he does. AJ Styles for the WWE World Heavyweight Championship.
He pulled up the wrong leg.
We weren't sure if AJ could hit it, but he did. About positioning being your savior in this matchup for Roman Reigns.
Vince comes out and says, no rope breaks.
Oh, and there are the
There's the Usos. No, wait, is this a flip? Is this a Roman to the outside?
Incredible match.
I mean, that's your 3-on-3 Extreme Rules main event, right? If you're still trying to semi keep AJ face, I don't think Finn's showing up.
Don't count out AJ Styles yet, though. We've seen what he's gone through in this match. It keeps responding.
I think it could be the next one that hits a big
what would be the main event? The champion and his two flunkies versus, you know, the number one contender and his two friends. Uh-oh. AJ, another phenomenal forearm. He's now eaten, what, three phenomenal forearms? Clean hit. One, two. Oh, Jesus.
AJ Styles is learning what Brock Lesnar found out, what Triple H found out.
AJ Styles had to believe right here, this moment, he had Roman Reigns right where he wanted him.
That's insane athleticism. Styles clash. Styles clash on Roman.
Roman Reigns trying to fight out of it. And he does. He sent Styles out of the ring.
Oh, no, Styles held on.
Styles caught Reigns. Who is going for the
one more phenomenal forearm.
Roman Reigns ducks underneath.
Spear.
Spear by Reigns.
Reigns launched himself into Styles.
Roman Reigns.
That was great. That was fucking great. That was fucking great. I loved every element of that. There's no overbooked. Come on. Come on. Are you not entertained? Wait, hold on. So let me get this straight. I'm pulling down all the audio. Let me get this straight. So if Roman had just beaten AJ clean, you would have preferred it. You would have preferred it if you want to call this overbooked. No, you have an unpopular champion who's a tweener in a hostile city against a babyface that is over all over the country, but very specifically over with these kind of fans. So what do? You have all this stuff. It furthers the Shane and Stephanie thing where they're both going to make changes, and this is going to be a new kind of era. This is going to be a fan-friendly era, or at least one in which when you are given a down, you get an up. And then ultimately, your champion goes over in a hard-fought, insane battle. How would you want literally anything else? How did we not get everything we wanted unless you just hate Roman Reigns and want him without the championship? If that is your point, then literally, you're getting worked, bro. Come on. Jeez, man. Y'all are killing me. It took five people to carry Roman through the match. Five people didn't give us, like, all the most memorable spots in that match. That was Roman Reigns and AJ Styles.
As the WWE World Heavyweight Champion.
Fun or not fun? Vote now. Thank God. Let's go ahead and take a look here. Oh, a little postscript.
Matter of fact, I think we're going to take a look at a... No, we're not going to take a look at a replay.
Well, nonetheless, we've seen it. I mean,
that was such a great match. It really was.
As a matter of fact, it seemed to me that, you know, I really applaud you, Shane, for walking out there, restarting the match. Way to go, no count out. But Steph, I already kind of one-upped him a little bit when he went out and did the no disqualification thing, and now we've had this great matchup, so congratulations to both of you.
Thank you.
Sort of off to a pretty good start, it relates to tomorrow night, but just wondering whether or not you think AJ should have a rematch.
Without question.
Of course. Yeah.
Really?
I agree.
There it is.
Okay, then what kind of match should he have and where should it be?
Well, Extreme Rules is in three weeks.
That's exactly the match that he should have. It should be an Extreme Rules matchup for the WWE World Heavyweight Championship between AJ Styles and Roman Reigns. Simple.
See you guys tomorrow night.
Shane, I just want you to know that I fully support your decision.
Thank you.
Shane and Steph gonna get along?
Look at that!
Well, nonetheless, Roman Reigns, AJ Styles will have their rematch, Extreme Rules, in 3 weeks in Newark, New Jersey. Roman Reigns, still your WWE World Heavyweight Champion. Well, coming up next, the new animated adult comedy.
And that'll be it. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages, that will conclude our WWE Payback stream. I want to thank everybody for hanging out with me. Listen, man, I like watching wrestling, but more so I like watching wrestling with y'all. It is always an honor and a pleasure to serve you. Thanks again to @AndrewZarian on Twitter, the guy from Queens who gathers other guys from Queens to create the Guys from Queens Network. And go ahead and let him know that you enjoyed him right here on this show. Also, everybody should go ahead and follow @AubreySitterson. He is going to do his Straight Shoot podcast live right after this. It should be starting in the next few minutes, so go ahead and check that out if you cannot get enough wrestling content. As for me, man, started at 12:30 doing Jury. Then it was 2 o'clock for Weird Things. Then 3:30 for After Things. And then it was a solid 3 hours to do this. The Wrestle Stream, I am done for this Sunday. I'm going to go ahead and check myself out some Game of Thrones and then maybe a little Silicon Valley and Veep alongside. But until next time, it is your friend Justin Robert Young @JustinRYoung on Twitter letting you know that we're restarting this match with no countouts. See you later, beautiful people.
Yeah. Yeah.